Waste floods off the crab's exoskeleton and back into the tide pools as the cycle of shit begins anew.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program where you may take control of the airwaves simply by dialing in toll free to join us here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I would like to also invite you to our Skype, where you can dial us up with Skype username lrn.fm. All you have to do is send a contact request first. Once we notice that come in, we'll approve it, and that takes usually no more than about a segment of the show. So once you're approved, it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype, and then you'll sound better than pretty much anybody that's ever on the phones with us. But the phones are still there, too. If you'd like to use that number, it's 855-450-FREE, and again, Skype us at username lrn.fm. The us tonight includes me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And we've got some sex-related stories here to start the show out with tonight. Mark had a story about this call girl. He's had it in his show prep for a few days, and we haven't had a chance to get to it. I did tease it a few times last night, and I feel like, you know, I feel an obligation to talk about this because, well, it's not nice to tease. Anyway, businessinsider.com. It's not nice to tease and then don't pay it off, I guess.
Well, sometimes it's nice to tease, and sometimes people pay the call girls to tease them.
It's true. If you're consenting to be teased, then that's one thing. But to tease somebody and not...
Oh, you're such a tease.
And, yeah, not give a payoff, that's not very nice. And then also on the way, speaking of call girls, Daryl, you've got a story about escort sites. Whether or not your pictures, not you, Daryl, necessarily, but you, the listener,
are being used
on escort sites.
I don't know what I would
say
to that.
That's the claim from Daily Dot.
So, I can tell where your minds are going.
And then, Danica, you've got a story about sleepover fears. Are parents getting way too freaked out over their daughters having sleepover parties?
Well, it's not just daughters. It applies to sons, too. But, yeah, I found this article, and I'm just kind of thinking, are people being a little paranoid?
Let's get into that here. When we get the chance, your calls, of course, come first if you make them at 855-450-FREE. This from businessinsider.com. In Super Freakonomics, we profiled a high-end escort whose entrepreneurial skills and understanding of economics made her a financial success. We call her Allie, which is neither her real nor professional name. There was so much interest in Allie after the book came out that she agreed to field reader questions on the blog. They are paraphrased below, along with Allie's answers. Question: can you tell us how you became an escort and what your family thinks or knows about your occupation? Answer: my parents don't know about my work or anything else about my sex life. I was a programmer when I decided to quit my job and become an escort. I was
probably single. Makes a lot better money being an escort.
I bet she does.
I remember reading this in Freakonomics. It's really interesting.
So you read the original? Because this is supposedly follow-up.
Oh, it's a follow-up.
Yeah,
okay.
So they had, I guess, an original interview with her.
Yes, there was the original, and it's a really, really fascinating read, so this should be interesting.
Yeah, this is brand new as of May 17th, so this came out within the last week, according to Business Insider. So she says, I was single and meeting people through a popular dating website. Finding someone special proved to be difficult, but I did meet many nice men. I'd grown up in a repressive small town, and I was, at that time, looking to understand my own sexuality. I've never attached my self-worth to some idea of virginity or monogamy, but I still had not really explored many of my desires. I was meeting people living alternative lifestyles, and as I got to know them, the stereotype that I'd built up started to come apart. During this time, I was in my mid-20s, and I had an active sex life. One day, I decided to enter the occupation of escort on an online instant messaging profile. Within seconds, I had many responses, and after about a week of talking to a few people, I decided to meet a dentist at a hotel. The experience wasn't glamorous or nearly as sexy as I thought that it might be. And how could it be, really? This is business, right? You know, somebody's
right.
Hiring.
Might be awkward, too.
Somebody is. Oh, I'm sure it is. Because, you know, think about it. Many of the men who would be buying the services of an escort or a prostitute are likely fairly awkward, you know, because maybe they're having trouble getting with women in other normal circumstances, or maybe they're just cheating on their wife and they're not so awkward. But
right, and there's the third category that most people don't think of, that are people that are very well off, mm-hmm. that have no trouble getting women, but have very, shall we say, interesting fetishes and desires.
Are we talking like 50 Shades of Grey or something like that? What are you getting at?
Sometimes that, sometimes just things that you don't really want to ask a normal person to do.
So like, too freaky for the
water sports,
okay,
if you will.
I imagine it would be hard to find an escort who's willing to do that as well.
No, actually not.
You've tried this?
No, I have not. I used to work at a jail.
Uh-huh.
And while they would not let the male guards work in the female unit.
Interesting.
The female guards would relay stories to us about conversations that they overheard.
So the female
in the
guards
female unit
would work in the male units?
Sometimes.
Okay.
And they would also work in the female unit,
right.
But the male guards would never work in the female unit.
Got it.
And most of the women that were in this particular jail were in for prostitution. And they would have conversations among one another about prices and various things.
Ah, okay.
And they would discuss prices for Golden Shower. And apparently the going rate as of 15 years ago was $450.
All right. Well, there you go. More information than you ever thought you'd learn about an act like that. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. So she says, however, I came away from the experience thinking it wasn't bad. I began to think that if I just had one appointment per month, I could pay my car loan with it and have a little extra money. Eventually, I chose to work as an escort exclusively. At that time, the reason I gave up my programming job was the free time. I was caring for a family member with a serious illness. The free time and money was a huge benefit.
Oh, yeah.
Question, do you have any moral problem with what you do? Answer, I do not have a moral problem with having sex for money as long as it's safe and between consenting adults. However, I have always been concerned about how the social and legal issues may affect my future and the people that I love.
So this brings up an interesting point that I like to bring up whenever somebody says, we need to ban prostitution.
It's already happened.
Right, but
keep it banned, you mean?
Right, keep it banned or in places where it's legal, like Nevada. Most of Nevada, it's legal. You know, it needs to be banned. Like, nobody should ever exchange anything for sex. And my question has always been, what is the moral difference between paying someone for sexual services and having a one-night stand with somebody that you bought drinks for at the bar?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Not a damn thing. And if somebody does think there's a difference, I want to hear the answer to the question at toll-free number 855-450-FREE.
Generally, the response that I get is, well, it's just different.
Sure.
But they can't different. Like, you know, explain how or why.
Because money is the root of all
different.
Evil. Is that it? Money's the root of all evil? As long as you're paying with alcohol, it's totally cool.
But it's not even money that's the root of all evil. It's the love of money that is listed as the root of all evil.
Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I think that there are a lot of people who do believe that money is the root of all evil.
Right.
I don't believe that. I want to make it clear I don't think that about money. I think money is a tool, and if you want to use money for evil, you can do that. If you want to use money for good, you can do that too.
Right.
And I don't think that there's anything immoral about selling sex. I mean, ultimately, you're trading something for sex.
Right.
Whether you're trading something as simple as drinks at a bar, like you're talking about, Daryl, or trading more time and effort, like, you know, courting someone, taking them out to dinner and, you know, spending time getting to know them. I don't want to make it sound like that's all mercenary just to get sex.
Right.
But certainly that's one of the benefits of having a relationship is that sex usually happens.
Right.
Amidst that.
And remember when Michelle Seven was on the show, she would talk about the various things that her and her ex-husband would come up with of, you know, you do laundry and I'll do this for you. You wash the dishes and, you know, X, Y, and Z.
Isn't that just chores, though? Isn't that what you normally do? Just right. Chores to do?
Well,
you can incentivize
the man
chores.
Doesn't necessarily do all of the chores, so she would incentivize the husband
I
to
see.
Do some of the chores.
So what kind of clients do you have is another question for the escort, the professional. She says, my clients are generally white, married, and professional males between 40 and 50 years old with incomes over $100,000 a year. She is a very high-end escort. They tend to be doctors, lawyers, and businessmen looking to get away for a few hours in the middle of the day. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here. We'll tell you more about this lady and what she has to say. 855-450-FREE. You can join us here and share your thoughts on prostitution. It's Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We're talking about the oldest profession, so they say. Prostitution, in this case, a very high-end prostitute, or aka an escort, which, of course, is just a front for prostitution, and everybody knows it. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. Also, you can check out some great liberty-oriented columns and articles and news over at freedomsphoenix.com. It's where they're uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies every day at freedomsphoenix.com. Readers over there are constantly provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. FreedomsPhoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com and get signed up for their free daily dispatch. That's FreedomsPhoenix.com. And, of course, the police state is certainly something that affects the folks in the prostitution business. The cops are frequently out in mid-to-large-sized cities doing undercover sting operations, trying to arrest Johns and prostitutes for just engaging in consensual behavior with one another most of the time. Sometimes there's some violence involved that either on the John side or the prostitute side. Certainly Johns have been robbed by prostitutes who will yes. have like some sort of bruiser who comes with them and robs the John, or the prostitute will just, you know, rob him while he's asleep or something like that. And then there's also Johns, who are violent psychopaths who will beat and severely maim or possibly murder prostitutes. So that works both ways. But that has more to do with the fact that prostitution is prohibited than it does anything that has to do with prostitution.
Right, because in the places where it's legal or, and I hate even talking about where it's regulated because, you know, like that's not really a free market there, but in the places to where the business can be conducted openly, you don't have these problems.
Exactly right. And that's because of, you know, open market competition. If you are openly running a brothel, then you can have security on site. You don't have to, you know, the girls today are having to meet clients in a lot of places like hotel rooms or motels and usually late at night. This young lady is saying she's meeting clients in the middle of the day and she's meeting very high-end clients. So odds are good she's going to be a little bit safer. She's actually vetting her clients, as we'll find out here in a moment. But, you know, a lower level prostitute isn't going to go through that much vetting. They yeah. just want to make some money.
Right. And there's a couple different kinds of prostitutes. There's the high end prostitutes that may or may not work through an agency. And the agency, if they do work through an agency, the agency does some vetting for them. If they don't work through an agency, they do their own sort of vetting. Mm-hmm. There's the more low end that still works through an agency where they do some vetting. And then there's the street walking
right.
prostitutes where there's absolutely no vetting at all.
Yeah, it's super
and it's
dangerous.
Generally the ones that are walking the streets that wind up running into the troubles.
Yep, that's absolutely the case. So if you want to share your thoughts, maybe your experiences in the world of prostitution as a John or a prostitute, or maybe as a cop. Maybe you're a cop that actually came around on this issue. Maybe, you know, because we've certainly talked over the years to cops who have changed their minds on the war on drugs. I don't know if we've ever talked to a cop who's sort of changed their mind through experience about the war on prostitutes and the war on Johns, if you
yeah.
will.
I don't know. I know I've read a lot of stories about cops that have used sex as basically a means of getting compliance from women that they've pulled over. Of say, if you give me this sexual favor, I will make your ticket go
oh, that,
away.
Yeah.
I'm sure, yeah.
That's and coercion, that, right?
Right. Like, but it's still, it's a form of prostitution because the way the laws are written in most places is receiving, I forget the exact wording used in New Hampshire, but it's basically receiving anything in exchange for.
That's an interesting claim.
So, like,
to me,
I would cook you supper and you do X, technically, if it's agreed upon beforehand, is prostitution.
I think that's not, I don't think it's fair to call that prostitution because prostitution is a consensual act between people. This is essentially sex slavery. I mean, this is forced sex slavery, is what it is. It's temporary, you know, in that the officer is, in most cases, going to let the person go and is probably not going to take them to their dungeon and lock them up and, you know, torture them for several months, years, or whatever. That's probably not going to happen. They're just going to perform the sex act. They're going to be let go. That's absolutely coercive, and I don't think it's fair to call that prostitution.
Well, based on the wording of the statute, and that's all I'm saying, based on the wording of statutes, that would be prostitution.
Okay.
I just pulled up the definition in New Hampshire. A person is guilty of a misdemeanor if the person solicits, agrees to perform, or engages in sexual contact or penetration in return for consideration.
The consideration being, I won't write you a ticket.
The consideration being anything. I won't write you the ticket.
So
I'll give you $20. I'll buy you drinks.
Anything like that.
Well, would I won't beat you also be consideration?
It could be.
I don't think you can say that.
I didn't write the statute.
I understand that, but
I
consideration
can only tell you what my interpretation of it
consideration is. Consideration is generally part of a contract. Consideration is something that you give in order to return, you know, in order to receive something in return as part of a voluntary agreement. As soon as you bring in a gun into that situation, I don't think you could really call that consideration because that's not a valid contract
right,
at that
point.
Right,
you're being forced to perform at that point.
Right, but there are so many things that you were forced to do, like the whole government with the consent of the governed. Your consent is forced consent. Because you have no way of opting out.
Well, right. I don't consider that consent. That's, you know, you're under the threat of violence. You do what you have to under the threat of violence. I don't know. You're welcome to share your thoughts on this. I think consideration is a word that has to do with contracts and agreements. And if there's
force
involved,
that's probably the intent behind what they wrote. But based on what they wrote, it could be anything.
Mm. Well, I highly doubt the cop is going to arrest the girl that he then has give him a BJ in return for letting her go on the speeding ticket.
Right,
for
and I don't think another cop is going to arrest the cop for doing it. I'm just saying technically, based on the wording of the statute, cops that force sexual favors should be arrested for prostitution plus sexual assault. Plus, they should be fired for being a horrible person.
But that would also mean the girl would be a prostitute as well, right? You would then, by definition, according to your interpretation, she would also be guilty of prostitution.
Some states only arrest the John.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. So anyway, here's more questions for the prostitute. The question is, how many of your clients are married men? Answer, almost all of my clients are married. I would easily say over 90%.
Hold on. Before you continue, let me skip down here. It is a felony in New Hampshire to compel another person by force or intimidation into performing a sex act.
Okay. That sounds more appropriate.
Yes.
So anyway, going on here, they are generally not men that couldn't have an affair if they wanted to, but the men who want this tryst with no strings attached, they're men who want to keep their lives at home intact, meaning that rather than have some girlfriend on the side that they have to keep happy.
They just want just a one-time thing usually. Or
they're going on
they
business.
Feel like it.
They're in Vegas or wherever it is they're going on business, and they call this girl so they can get some action and then not have her bother them later on and call their cell phone the wrong time or something. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering from EP? The symptoms include fraudulent charges to your credit card. Your subway card says it's empty, but you bought it yesterday. Someone's been in your hotel room, but the desk clerk says they only show you entering the room. These are signs of EP, electronic pickpocketing. Payment cards, transit cards, even hotel room keys use a radio chip, so you can just wave your card at the register, the turnstile, or your hotel room door. But what's convenient for you is also convenient for thieves, waving scanners to electronically pickpocket you without even touching you. The good news is there's a cure. ID Stronghold has created leather wallets and clutches that have built-in EP protection. Layers of shielding material cleverly concealed in a beautiful leather wallet that stops the symptoms of EP. Go to IDStronghold.com now and get the cure. IDStronghold.com. Warning, ID Stronghold wallets could lead to feelings of safety and security, comfort in crowds, and euphoria. If you experience these emotions, immediately inform your friends and family about IDStronghold.com so they can feel better too.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the Ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can dial toll-free to join us here on the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the interview here conducted by the authors of Freakonomics, and now I guess they have Super Freakonomics. They are Stephen Levitt and Stephen Dubner. They are doing a follow-up interview with one of the people that they put in their book originally, Allie, who is a prostitute or an escort, very high-end. Her customers make an average of $100,000 per year. They're between 40 and 50 years old, doctors, lawyers, businessmen, those kind of folks. And we got more questions here for her to answer. We're going to get into more of it here in moments. But first, let's go to Armed Truth, calling from South California or South Carolina. I'm not sure. Where are you, Armed Truth?
Southern California.
Excellent, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah. Well, I have one thing regarding, I was listening to the podcast from yesterday at work today about Johnson and his upset, you know, how he was about New Hampshire. I just have to say, I think you guys do a good job. And the way you describe it, my brother moved there for a while and he really enjoyed it. He had to leave because of his job. But I don't know, Johnson just kind of sounded like, a little child, like a kid who was, you know, the kid in high school gets, someone makes a comment to him and he is upset forever about it or something. I don't know.
He was being a very negative Nancy last night about the Free State Project.
Okay, so for those of us that weren't listening, can you fill us in?
Yeah, that's what I was about to do. So last night on the show, there was a discussion towards the end of the program where Johnson was claiming that on Free Talk Live, we have oversold New Hampshire and how great the community is here. And he says he believes it needs to be undersold. I feel like we've been very fair with how we've talked about New Hampshire here on Free Talk Live. We had James actually call in, who's a relatively new mover. He lives in Dover, and he called in to say he felt like we'd been underselling it, that the community was even better than he had imagined it to be based on what he heard.
But, I mean, it really depends on the crowd that you hang out with, because you know some people that are just so severely jaded with, you know, you, for example.
Sure. Yeah,
but you're
going to
find that in any community, really.
I mean, as far as the community, though, do you feel, Danica, that the Free State Project was oversold to you or undersold?
Something
else?
That is a really good question. I was thinking about that, listening to it, because I was also listening to it at work. And I think in some ways I was not prepared for some of the, I don't want to say struggles because that sounds like too big of a word, but there were definitely some surprises that I was not prepared for. I think overall it's great, but I've mostly been here in Keene. I haven't really been out to Manchester or Portsmouth or any of the other kind of hubs to see what that community is like.
So what was one of the struggles you weren't expecting?
I was not expecting how expensive everything was, and the job that I have does not pay as well as I was kind of led to believe.
But that doesn't have anything to do with the community,
right? Exactly.
It's here,
just
right?
It's mostly just about New Hampshire itself. Yeah. I think for the most part, the people that I have been able to interact with are for the most part great people. You know, I enjoy working with you, Ian. I enjoy being your friend. I enjoy working with Daryl, and I enjoy working with different kinds of people. But I've definitely met some sketchy people that I would just never want to associate with.
Sure.
But again, you're going to find that in any community.
Yeah, and that's what I've said is that, you know, if you've got 1,000 people and we have 1,700 of them here now in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, there's a good chance some of them are not going to be who they claim to be. Some of them are going to be people that are trying to take advantage of others. And, you know, you definitely need to be careful when you're meeting new people.
Absolutely.
And there is a sort of a mindset of, it's Libertopia and now I can trust everyone. And if you come into it with that mindset, then you're likely to, at some point, encounter someone who's willing to take advantage of you. And that's not a black mark on the movement or anything like that. That's just a statement about human beings and
yes.
numbers of human beings.
Right. And you also have the people that basically want to stir drama, if you will. So there are, you know, times when I will refer to the Free State Project as the Drama State Project, because it seems as though there's a small group of people, and it is a small group of people, that every time you turn around, they're starting something with somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, really, more drama from this guy? And it's always the person that says, I don't like drama. It just seems to find me.
Yeah.
Gee, I wonder why that is.
Right. So, Armed Truth, your thoughts?
Yeah, exactly. I got to agree with Daryl. It's my whole take from what Johnson was saying is exactly that. He says, the drama, I don't want the drama. But it sounds like that's all he is a part of is drama. He's exactly, it's, to me, I don't know him personally, obviously, but it kind of sounded like that. I don't know. That's what I was thinking today. But what I really was calling in about was just with the whole police state and all the murders, you know, that are going on. It kind of bugs me that all that people talk about is race, and it's always, you know, Black Lives Matter and it's race, when instead of separating everybody by this race boundary, instead, why isn't it not the citizens versus the state versus the police? They throw race into it, and it kind of, to me, it deviates from the real problem. The root of the problem is the police itself. And then so when you bring race into it, then people who otherwise maybe would support against the police, it's this big divide. I don't know. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to give you a three-word answer, and it basically explains everything to where stuff gets fragmented. Are you ready? Divide and conquer. So you get people to fight amongst one another instead of against, you know, like the bigger, more oppressive entity, and, well, now there's not a united front to say, like, you know, police right. should stop killing people, because you have some people that are saying, well, police need to stop killing black people. And other people are like, wait, what about the, you know, white people that got murdered? Oh, well, they don't matter because white privilege.
Yeah,
I totally agree with Daryl on this one. I think that, you know, when you talk to people on the ground and you can see this in like places like Baltimore and in Missouri as well, in Ferguson, where I think it was Michael Brown's sister or one of his family members made a statement about, you know, this isn't about black versus white. This is about the police.
It's a power struggle.
Yeah, this is about the police and abuse from the police across the board. I saw similar comments from people in Baltimore as well. But when you look at the mainstream media's narrative of it, it's all about the race.
Right.
And so that's a way to distract the viewers from the real problem, which is, of course, police abuse and violence on the part of the police and out-of-control cops and no accountability and, you know, all the problems with the police. If you can make it seem like, oh, well, it's all about race and, you know, some bad cops, there's only a few bad apples and we need to get rid of the racist cops and have some reforms, that makes it seem like it's less of a problem than it really is, I think. And so I share the concerns, and I think the only thing we can really do about it is create our own media, which we're doing. You know, we've got Free Talk Live, and of course there's the Free Thought Project and copblock.org. These are two great websites that do a fine job of cataloging police violence and abuse. Photography is not a crime, .com. You know, we can create our own media today that can compete with the mainstream media and get a more accurate message about what the problem really is out there.
And Ian, I just want to add something before we throw it back to Armed Truth. You mentioned something that is a huge pet peeve of mine. When people say just a few bad apples, they never finish the idiom. The idiom is a few bad apples spoil the bunch.
That's true. Yeah.
It's not a few bad apples and the rest of the apples are okay. No, a few bad apples make the whole batch terrible.
Right. Yep. Armed Truth, any other thoughts? Go ahead.
Yeah, that's a great point, Daryl. They never do finish that. And that's the whole meaning of the saying, is that a few bad apples ruins everything. But they, you know, they choose to leave that out. So, yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head. I thought those are great points, and hopefully it'll change. And between your guys' show and LRN, I'm a big fan of Scott Horton's show as well.
Cool.
You know, change. You know, it's. I think it's a good thing. So, yeah, hopefully it'll change. And,
thanks, dude.
I don't know. It's with you guys, yeah.
Appreciate the call tonight, Armed Truth. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. We've got more coming up from the escort, high-end call girl. She's answering some questions from the readers of not just Business Insider here, that's where it's being published, but the Freakonomics authors, who apparently you would have read the original Danica, the original
yes.
interview with this young lady, Allie, which is not her real name or her professional name. But there are now questions from readers that they wanted to know from this young lady about her career as an escort. We'll find out more about it here in a moment. And your calls and thoughts are also welcome at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us here on the radio on Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free to join us here. Your thoughts on prostitution certainly are welcome. Escort services. We're specifically talking about a high-end call girl. Here at businessinsider.com with a story from the authors of Freakonomics. They're following up with a young lady that they interviewed for their book, and they got a bunch of questions from some of their readers what they wanted to ask this high-end prostitute, and we're going to continue with some of those questions and answers. But maybe you've had experience in the business, either on the side of a John or the prostitute side, so you're welcome to share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE, or on the enforcement side as well, 855-450-FREE. As we continue here, the story from Business Insider. How many of your clients are married men? She says over 90%. They're the kind of men who's, you know, making over $100,000 a year. They're going out on business. They would like to have sex, but they would prefer to not have to cultivate a girlfriend, right? Because cultivating a girlfriend would mean
that takes work.
Yeah, there's work
and two
involved.
Two cell phones.
Two cell phones, phone calls, text messages, emails, and then, you know, you got to hide that stuff because most of these guys are probably cheating on their wives.
Right.
Question, what do your clients' wives know or think about them coming to you? Answer, I rarely got the opportunity to find out if the wives were okay with it, but I did see several couples, so I assume they were okay with it. I suspect that many of the wives are not aware and would not be okay with it, but nonetheless, that's just my suspect. That's what I suspect. Now, a question here. Do you know the real names of your clients? Yes, always. I insist that they give me their full names and their place of work so that I can contact them there before we meet. I also check their identification when we meet. I also use verification companies, which assist escorts in verification of clients. These companies do the verification of the client and put them in a database so that when the client wants to meet with a girl for the first time, he doesn't have to go through the verification process again. For a fee, I can call in and they will tell me if the client has a history of giving the girls problems, where he works, and his full name. Question, what are your out-of-pocket costs? Answer, $300 to $500 a month for my online basic ads, $100 a year for the website, $100 a month for a phone, and $1,500 a year for photography.
Hold on. She needs a cheaper cell phone if it's costing her $100 a month.
Yeah, a lot of people pay about $100 a month for a
phone.
Yeah,
it's typically average.
What?
Verizon, when I was with Verizon, it was $100 a month easy.
Yeah,
I'm paying $35 a month.
Well, yeah. I mean, you can get the monthly plans, but I don't know. Maybe she really likes 4G or something.
Okay, if I went with the company that I have to get the unlimited text, talk, and data, it would cost me, I think, $55 or $60
Well, she probably wants a better phone so that no matter where she goes, she's probably will get better coverage. That's one of the reasons why Verizon tends to be more expensive is that they cover a lot of the U.S., whereas maybe Sprint. I mean, Sprint doesn't have a lot of coverage here in New Hampshire, for example, and sometimes I can't get a signal or squad.
Well, now
I'm on the Sprint network, and the only place that I don't get coverage that most other people do is north of Concord.
Well, now look, when you're on Straight Talk from Walmart, they have different providers that they contract with. So I can get a. I've got a Straight Talk phone. The phone I have actually runs on Verizon Towers. So I have that Verizon coverage. But what it wouldn't run on would be any of the partners that Verizon has done deals with. So if Verizon has an agreement with Sprint to provide them service in areas where Verizon doesn't have coverage, this phone wouldn't work on those Sprint towers. So you don't get the. I don't think you get the full Verizon roaming coverage out of this. You just get like the actual Verizon coverage out of it. So the coverage isn't quite as good as the Verizon package. Plus, with the monthly plans like you and I are on, Daryl, I don't think you're getting 4G, and I don't think you would get 4G for $45 a month.
Probably not,
when
no.
I'm in a place that actually has 4G, like Manchester or Concord, I get 4G.
You do?
Right. When I'm there, I get 4G, but I don't get any 4G here in Keene. I never had
That's
it on
Keene
Sprint.
That's because Keene doesn't have 4G.
I realize that. I'm just saying I've never gotten
not
any sort of...
That's true.
Not for Sprint. I know AT&T has 4G here, but that's the only provider I know of that has 4G here.
So anyway, back to this young lady's story. She says, if I was touring, then there would be extra expenses such as travel costs, hotels, and more advertising costs. Question, do you have any regrets about your chosen profession? Answer, being an escort provided me with many opportunities that I'm not sure I would have gotten had I not been an escort. That said, my choice to become an escort had a definite cost associated with it beyond the advertising, photos, and websites. I believe it is close to impossible to have a healthy relationship while working, so it can be a lonely life. In addition, hiding my job from my friends and family proved to be difficult for many reasons. And I imagine that it could be difficult to have this career because I wonder how many guys would be okay with it. I mean, there's a real possessiveness between in relationships, at least in the United States. I don't know about other countries and how people interact there.
Honest question for you two. If you met a girl and you thought she was great, she seemed like a really awesome girl, and you found out that she was a high-end escort, not just an escort, but someone like this, like Allie, who was making pretty good money, would you be okay with her job?
I'd be fine with it as long as she was being safe and you know,
right, she was
and
using protection. How about you, Daryl?
I will have to concur with Ian.
All right.
Question, how do you think prostitution would change if it were legalized?
But before you answer that question, something that you had mentioned where she said about it was difficult to have a healthy relationship.
Right.
Close
to impossible, she says.
Right. I recall seeing a story a couple of days ago about an escort from, I think it was Australia, who the story was she had been an escort for like 10 or 12 years, had slept with like 10,000 guys, and wow. Now she's looking for love. Like she's you know, done with the business. She's made all the money she wants to make. Now she's looking for love, and apparently thousands of guys have already proposed to this woman that they have never met.
Wow. Okay.
And my guess is they're thinking, okay, sugar mama.
Hmm. Yeah, it could be.
Yeah, that's an interesting question. If I guess the same question would apply if a girl was formerly an escort and claims that she was no longer in the business, would you be okay with dating her?
I don't see what the problem would be with that. But yeah, you can make a lot of money at this, right? I mean, if you're doing a high-end clientele and you don't put the money you're making up your nose or in your arm or something like that, then you can make a lot of money.
Right.
And so if you have the ability to save that money, then you could retire relatively quickly as a high-end escort. So the next question for her is, how do you think prostitution would change if it were legalized? Would you want your own child to become a prostitute? Now, it's two different questions, but going on here. Answer. If the social and legal ramifications were gone, I think that being an escort might be like being a therapist. I've never been a therapist, so my knowledge is obviously limited. Like most escorts, a therapist sells his or her skills by the hour. A therapist also has to meet people for the first time, not knowing who's walking in the door, and many have their own offices and work alone. In addition, the session is generally private and requires discretion. I imagine that many times therapists have patients that they like and some they don't. A therapist's revenue, like almost all other occupations, probably increases if a client feels that the therapist likes them. I don't mean to imply that I have the skills of a trained therapist or to in any way demean what they do. I'm just observing some obvious similarities. If I had a child, before she goes on with the child answer, the question about therapy, I think I agree with her on that. I mean, there's just so much loneliness in this world and people who don't have the social skills to interact with somebody of the opposite or same sex or whatever it is their sex they're attracted to have the ability to pay someone to have a conversation or to, you know, have sex or whatever, because a lot of what goes on in the world of the underground sex trade, at least from my understanding of it, having known women who've worked in this trade, there's a lot of guys that just want to talk. They just want to have someone to talk to and someone to
absolutely
to listen to them. So
and
there's
I think
a lot of that.
At some point in the interview, in the book at least, she talks about how one of the, I guess, strangest experiences she had was that all the guy wanted to do is talk. Like there was no,
yep,
there
no
was
sex.
No sex whatsoever. They were just sitting and talking for a couple of hours and that was it.
Yep, I totally believe that. And I think that's probably more common than
I agree.
Really,
I agree too.
Really,
yeah,
think.
And I've got a couple of friends that used to be call girls.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the stories that they've told me, it's just that. Like, you know, some guy that might be a little older doesn't really want to, you know, try doing the dating thing, calls up the girl, she comes over, and they just, like, stay up all night talking.
Yep.
Because he's lonely. He wants a attractive female to spend time with him. And so, like, the disclaimer that they put out of the money that you pay me is for my time only, and
yep,
anything else that happens is for or between consenting adults.
Right.
You know, most people are like, yeah, okay, like, you're getting paid to go have sex.
Usually they
but
probably
sometimes
are.
In some way she's
you're
a therapist.
Not. So, you know, sometimes yeah, it is just
amateur
time
therapy
being spent together.
Right. So we'll come back with more. And the other question was, what if she had a child? Would she want her own child to become a prostitute? So we'll share that with you here in moments. And there's a few more questions as well. We'll get to those. 855-450-FREE. Then on the way, Daryl's got a story about photos of yours maybe being stolen for an escort website. There's more coming up here. It's Free Talk Live.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, May 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.25 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,212 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports the USA Freedom Act, which got its start as an NSA reform bill and has turned into a watered-down extension of the NSA surveillance program in general, is passed in the House, and Senate leaders have announced a Saturday vote on their version. The Senate is facing strong opposition on both sides from those opposed to surveillance and those wanting an even more straightforward approval. Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky already spoke against the bill, and some amendments are seemingly going to be needed to pass the bill. But if the USA Freedom Act needs to be reconciled with the House version, it may be too late, as the House has already gone into recess for the holiday. The Senate's alternate plan, also set for a Saturday vote, would be to try to extend the NSA surveillance for 2 months, giving them more time to sell a permanent extension. There, too, however, is no House approval, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claims assurances from House leaders that they won't try to push any short-term extension bill with virtually everyone gone on recess.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
UPI reports a Baltimore grand jury on Thursday handed down indictments for six police officers for their alleged role in the death of Freddie Gray. Baltimore City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby announced the indictments during a news conference on Thursday afternoon. When she announced those initial charges earlier in the month, all six police officers were arrested and released on bond. After the grand jury review process, reckless endangerment charges were added for all six officers, while false imprisonment charges were dropped. Officer Caesar Goodson Jr. was indicted on charges of second-degree depraved heart murder, involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, gross negligence manslaughter by vehicle, criminal negligence manslaughter by vehicle, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Goodson faces the most serious punishment of 30 years in prison for the murder charge. Officer William Porter and Sergeant Alicia White were each indicted on charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Lieutenant Brian Rice was indicted on charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, two counts of misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Officer Edward Nero and Garrett Miller were each indicted on charges of second-degree assault, two counts of misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Freddie Gray died on April 19th, 1 week after sustaining a spinal cord injury while in police custody.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports, Boy Scouts of America President Robert Gates said on Thursday that the group's ban on adult gay leaders needs to end, taking a step towards dismantling a policy that has caused deep rifts in the 105-year-old organization. Gates said at the group's national meeting in Atlanta that he does not plan to revoke the charters of Boy Scout councils that allow gay leaders. As Secretary of Defense, Gates helped end the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy that barred openly gay individuals from serving in the military. He said he was not asking the Boy Scouts National Board to make any policy changes at the current meeting. The Irving, Texas-based organization lifted its ban on gay youth in 2013, but continues to prohibit the participation of openly gay adults. This election last year of Gates as president of the Boy Scouts was seen as an opportunity to revisit the policy. Gates said he personally would have supported going further towards lifting the Scouts' ban on gay adults, but would not reopen the debate during his two-year term. The policy received
received its first major challenge in April when the first openly gay adult was hired as a summer camp leader by the Greater New York Council of Boy Scouts. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
With job numbers near historic lows, Forbes magazine has released a list of tips for finding a job, all of which involve witnessing an employer murder someone. Forbes says despite the grim economy, employers are still hungry for talented workers who know how important it is to forget about whatever they think they saw or heard.
So me and a couple of friends were out smoking at the Viaduct the other day, and we saw this really rich guy in a Mercedes pull up in his car and drop nothing. Now I'm the vice president of international development.
According to Goldman Sachs CEO Lloyd Blankfein, we had a great quarter and hired hundreds of new employees. I haven't done anything wrong, and all my employees will tell you the same thing because that's the deal we had. But the article warns that stumbling onto a coke-fueled CEO strangling a prostitute isn't a foolproof method for finding work, because employers are just as likely to murder you as they are to hire you.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. Join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features there on the site. They are completely free. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. With you in studio, it's Ian,
Danica,
and Daryl.
We've been talking, for those of you just tuning in, about a high-end call girl, an escort, prostitute, whatever you'd like to call her. She is doing business selling sex for money, and usually to very, very high-end clients, like people that make over $100,000 a year, businessmen, lawyers, doctors, those kind of folks who just want to have sex with somebody without any strings attached. And we're going to get back into some more of these questions that Business Insider and the authors of Freakonomics, Stephen Levitt and Stephen Dubner, have for her. So we'll continue that in a moment. But first, James is listening in Kalamazoo. James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Good evening. I ran into a story that was kind of so preposterous, I just wanted to share it.
Sure.
A girl actually got suspended her last 30 minutes of high school, so the last day of school that she'd go to high school, for wearing a dress that was still very modest but came up maybe 2 or 3 inches too high.
So does the suspension mean she doesn't graduate or something?
In the story, the teacher claims that she yelled, even though witnesses say she didn't, and then actually threatened when she went to say, you know, stand up for herself, and said that he would keep her from getting her diploma.
So the teacher,
last 30 minutes.
The teacher threatened her, saying that he would keep her from getting her diploma because she was wearing a skirt that was too short.
Because she didn't want to leave. She had been at school all day, and It was like her last class. The teacher decided to make a stink. I found it on the Huffington Post. It shows you a picture of her in the dress, and it's a very modest dress. And her thing is, I dress how I feel. I felt like wearing this today, and I wore it, went all day, and then last 30 minutes of high school, the teacher decided to suspend her.
I saw something that is somewhat related to what you're saying, James. I forget exactly who wrote it or the exact wording, but I will paraphrase it thus. When you tell a girl that she has to leave school because she's dressed inappropriately, what you're saying is that making boys not feel uncomfortable is more important than her education.
I guess so. I guess that's what they think. I don't know. It was just crazy. You know, the family is fighting, you know, to have it taken off of her record because that could affect, you know, college in the future for her.
Sure, absolutely.
You know, never been in trouble in school in her entire life, decided to wear the wrong outfit. And yeah.
Yeah, I found the story here over at Huffington Post, as you suggested. She is, Yvette Rae. She's 18, and Apparently, it is a this modest green shift. Do they mean shirt? Is shift a type of women's apparel?
Shift?
A shift? Shirt, perhaps?
Hey, can you spell it?
S-H-I-F-T, as in shift.
Oh, I've not heard of that.
Is that a mistype, perhaps? Anyway.
Probably.
Rie told Yahoo, I love the dress. I have no regrets about wearing it, and I would wear it again any day. The fashion showdown escalated when she refused to obey the teacher who ordered her to go home and change into something that complied with the dress code. The teacher upped the ante, threatening to call the superintendent, withhold her diploma. Ray said she relented and called her mother to bring a different outfit, but by then school officials had already suspended her for insubordination. She says,
how dare you question our authority?
Yeah. Well, that's the big crime, isn't it, to not obey? And James, thanks for bringing the story to the forefront.
That's really the only crime.
Exactly.
Is to not obey.
It's certainly the one they take the most seriously. If you don't do what the government agents say, they come at you harder than pretty much anything else.
Right, but that's pretty much, you know, I dare say 80% of things that will get you either arrested or get you a ticket is just not doing what they say.
Levitt and the school's principal, Tyler Telford, told Ray's mother that her daughter conducted herself poorly during the argument. They allege she got in Levitt's face, Levitt being the teacher. While she holds that she remained at least 4 feet away from him, Westside School District Superintendent Spencer Barzi told the Huffington Post that state and federal laws prevent him from discussing an individual student's discipline. He added, in my own opinion, there must be a lull in news if you're covering this story. But punishing female students for violating rigid dress codes comes up again and again, and many see this as a chauvinistic way of treating girls and young women. You're welcome to share your thoughts with us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Juliet Bond, a parent to a student at Haven Middle School in Evanston, Illinois, says, for me, it's about shaming girls about their bodies. It's this message across genders that girls have to cover up, and teachers saying to girls that the reason for this rule is so boys aren't distracted. Experts back her up. Carrie Preston, a Boston University professor, says it's certainly going to give women the idea that exposure of their bodies is a negative thing. There's discomfort with the sexuality of minors, but these concerns are not best addressed.
Let me tell you, as a teenager going to a school where there was a dress code that, you know, if girls were to wear shorts, they had to be, I forget if it was, you know, so close to the knee or past the fingertips when they held the hand down by their leg. But, you know, some girls have longer legs than others, so those shorts would be a little bit shorter than the other ones.
And
some girls would wear really tight pants, and I was distracted by all of it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I totally agree with you, Daryl. High school teenage boys are going to be checking out the girls in the class, period, regardless of whether the skin is being shown or not.
Regardless if they're wearing, like, sweatpants and a hoodie, they're going to be looking at them.
I love a girl in sweatpants.
Is that right?
See, I know
guys that
hate sweatpants.
Scrubs. Oh, I love scrubs.
Like, what is a scrub?
Like
is
medical
like
scrubs.
Like what nurses wear.
Girls wear that to school?
Nursing students do.
Okay. Not in high school, I hope. Unless they're going to volunteer at the Humane Society.
I think Daryl's revealing a fetish here tonight.
Not
on
a fetish.
We
better go find an escort that specializes in that.
In scrubs.
Naughty nurses.
All right. 850, that's enough. 855, 450, free. You can share your thoughts here. You know, what's not clear, though, is the suspension of this young lady. Is that going to somehow put her in jeopardy? The teacher,
it goes on her permanent record.
Who cares? Who looks at that stuff? Does anybody in a job ever pull up the permanent record of someone in high school, like some human resources director?
It depends on the college that you're wanting to go to, but if the college is really prestigious, they're going to look at that. But if it's like a community college, I don't think they really care about that. I could be wrong.
She could just be an escort and never have to go to college and, you know, probably retire by 25.
I don't even know where my permanent record would be. And the reason I say that is because after I graduated, the high school that I graduated from separated itself from the County Board of Education. So I don't know if the County Board of Education has my permanent record or if the newly created school district got all of those documents from the County Board of Education.
It would be interesting to pull up my permanent record to see like what all the referrals are in there that I got when I was in high school, because I don't remember them all. You know,
did you ever get in trouble in high school?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, yes.
So I wonder what it would say about that.
So yeah, it would be fun because it would like stir. Maybe it would stir some memories of it because I can't remember what.
But after a certain point, there's kind of like, okay, this is what, over 20 years old. This has no relevancy. He's obviously
absolutely
a very
yeah.
different person than that.
Yeah, a totally different person today than I was in high school.
There are some people that think that people never change.
I can't imagine why.
Hmm. Share your thoughts with us. Toll free, 855-450-FREE, whether it's on school dress codes. It's still not clear, though, from having read this story. The teacher seems to think that this is going to withhold her diploma. But, I mean, one suspension... If this is the only time that this girl's ever gotten in trouble in school, I highly doubt.
Yeah, I highly doubt they would withhold it from her.
Yeah,
but who knows? Maybe he's just being a jerk just to be a jerk.
Well, the teacher can't decide to...
Right. The teacher can just make threats.
Right. So, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Coming back, we've got a couple more questions for the high-end call girl. She's going to answer, does she have any regrets about her profession? Oh, excuse me. Would she want her own child to be a prostitute? That's the one we left off on. We'll get to that one here in moments. And your calls and thoughts are welcome. Maybe you are a prostitute or you've been a John or whatever. Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners. So you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
I mean, it's just so hard to believe that it's really all gone.
It was in this living room 3 weeks ago that the Talbot family discovered their DVR had suddenly and inexplicably crashed, deleting more than 5 years' worth of recorded live events and miniseries.
I keep having flashbacks to that day, to that moment when I realized everything was gone.
You know, you hear stories about people who mismanage their device settings, but you never really think it could happen to you. Honestly, it feels like some sort of a dream, like... When I wake up, I'll be able to just go downstairs, turn on the TV, and all the episodes will be there again, as if nothing had ever happened.
Friends and family of the Talbots have pledged their support, organizing DVD donations and offering passwords to online streaming services while the family struggles to move on.
We know that we'll never be able to replace all the hours of programming that we had, but I think in the end, we'll be just fine. As long as we have our 5 seasons of Seinfeld on DVD.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get email announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio waves, toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio tonight, you've got Ian here.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And Express Coin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Whether it's Bitcoin, Litecoin, or Dogecoin, Express Coin is fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get your cryptocurrency with money order or a check by starting off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can help you at ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app from ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL and get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency with no fee at all for the transfer. Go to ExpressCoin.com to get started, and don't forget to use coupon code FTL. That's ExpressCoin.com. We are continuing a story that we started in the last hour from Business Insider. It is an interview with a prostitute, a very high-end lady. She's dealing with clients that make over $100,000 a year. She's taking time and effort and spending money to vet her clients to make sure that she's not, you know, coming up against some sort of psychopath who wants to stab her to death or something horrible like that, as can happen in the lower end of the prostitution business, sort of with the street-walking prostitutes. So, again, it's an interview with a high-end call girl, which obviously is going to be different than an interview with a streetwalker. But the next question that we have not yet given her a chance to answer is, would you want your own child to become a prostitute? And she says that if I had a child, I would hope that they would feel empowered and have the opportunity to do whatever they desire to do, and that they would be in charge of their own sexuality. This job has its downsides, though, and can take a high toll on a person. I know that it's made many aspects of my life and my relationships more difficult. So, like any parent, I would always want more for my child than I had for myself. Question, are you in favor of legalization? And the answer is, I feel that prostitution should be legal. If a couple meets for dinner and a bottle of wine and have sex, that's a date. If they meet for dinner and a bottle of wine and have sex with money in an envelope left on the dresser, that's illegal. And that comes back around to one of the points you were making earlier, Daryl, that there is no fundamental difference between what happens with a deal for prostitution versus picking somebody
right,
up at a bar
and,
going out to dinner.
Yeah, you know, well, what if they are a couple and they go out, have dinner, have a glass of wine, go back, have sex, and the husband leaves money on the counter for the wife to go shopping the next day?
Mm-hmm.
How is that,
How's that different?
It's not different at all.
Well, right, because it's under the marriage license, then all of a sudden it's no longer prostitution, right?
I didn't say married. I just said a couple.
You did say husband, though.
Yeah, I think you did say husband.
Okay, well, you can be husband and wife without having the government paperwork.
That's very true.
I realize there are women in prostitution, she says, who are there because they feel like they have to be. These women work for in a different part of the industry than I did. Many have drug or abuse issues, among other problems. I think instead of spending time and finite resources on arresting and criminalizing these women, we should spend our resources on making sure these women have other opportunities and a place to go for help. Now, of course, one thing that could, I think, assist in this circumstance is to legalize drugs. Because drugs are so expensive due to the fact that they're illegal, that prohibition drives up the price of these drugs, means that having to turn tricks is one way that you can get the money that you need for the drugs that you're addicted to without having to go and, you know, rob people or break into houses or something like
right.
that.
Right. And just for, you know, anybody that's new to the show, when you talk about, you know, making drugs legal, you're not talking about it from the tax and regulate standpoint of making them legal.
Good point.
You're talking about remove the
repeal. Repeal prohibition.
Statute that makes them illegal.
Exactly. And let the market take care of distribution without any bureaucrats sticking their hands out and getting involved. She goes on here to say the women who don't want to be prostitutes shouldn't have to be, and they should be able to get the help that they need. Women who want to be able to should be able to. I feel that no one should have to take a job to make a living that is against his or her own moral judgment. Question, how would legalization affect your business model? Answer, well, I'm sure it would cause me to lower my rates. I'm sure more people would take up prostitution as a profession, and I'm sure more men would partake in the activity. That said, legalization does not remove all the barriers to entry. The job would still have huge negative stigma associated with it, both for the escorts and the clients. In countries like Canada, enforcement of prostitution laws is extremely lax, and while rates are lower, they aren't wildly different. So there would still be men out there afraid of their wives finding out, and I still wouldn't want to share my job title with my family.
And one of the stigmas, let's just think about strippers for a second. That's perfectly legal in the U.S. to be a stripper, but there's still a lot of stigma attached to that.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
In a lot of places, especially the more conservative areas.
And, you know, if you've been a stripper, you've been a prostitute, John, you want to share your thoughts with us here, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We're through all of the questions for the high-end call girl in this particular circumstance. But yeah, having known a couple of strippers in my time, it is a tough life, and they do have to deal with, and at least when you're a stripper, you're dealing with lower end clientele as well in a lot of cases, right? So you're dealing with the guys who you don't know who they are. They've literally walked through the door. They've given whatever the cover charge is to get into this place. Unless we're talking about some super high-end strip club, I don't think most of them are that way. I've never actually been to one, and I don't really have any interest in going to one because they always seem kind of scuzzy to me. But I've known people who've worked in them.
I've been to exactly two strip clubs.
Mm-hmm. Where? Down south?
Both of them were south.
Okay.
The first time, it was in Tijuana, Mexico. I was 18. Was visiting my brother out in San Diego, and my brother and my dad said, let's go to Tijuana for the day. And so we're down in Tijuana, and then my brother drags me and my dad into a strip club.
All right. Oh. Older brother?
Older brother. Yeah. And so the three of us are sitting there, and this very attractive woman.
Had you seen a naked woman before?
On TV.
Okay.
So very attractive woman comes over topless.
Yep.
Starts essentially groping me. I'm loving it.
Okay.
My dad freaks out, hands up a handful of money and says, here's money, go away.
Oh my God.
Here's money to not touch my son.
Yes.
So she did.
And she took the money and went away.
Yep. Did you say something like, Dad, come on.
I was just in shock about the whole thing because I didn't want to go into a strip club with my father in the first place.
A little awkward, yeah.
The second time that I went to a strip club, I was living in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Okay.
And South Carolina has this weird law that women cannot go to a strip club unless accompanied by a man.
What? Okay.
And I had a lesbian roommate.
All right.
She wanted to take her girlfriend to a strip club. And so they drug me along because I had to be their male escort.
So one man could accompany two women to the strip club? Okay.
Yeah. So I was their accompaniment.
What's the reason for that?
They claim it's to prevent prostitution.
Oh.
But it seems to me that would not do that at all because then the pimps just take their girls to the club.
Yeah.
It seems backwards logic to me.
Danica.
So, yeah, the second time that I went to a strip club, I took my lesbian roommate and her girlfriend.
Have you ever been to a strip club?
Yeah, many times. It's great fun.
Many times.
Okay. I'll have to tell you that when we come back.
We'll talk about it coming up here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts here on Free Talk Live.
This is a nationwide announcement for consumers owing back taxes to the IRS. The slowdown in the U.S. economy has forced renewed action by the Internal Revenue Service. The IRS is now accepting reduced settlement amounts from qualifying consumers who owe back taxes. If you're eligible, your back tax settlement may be discounted by thousands of dollars. A specially assigned national hotline has been directly routed to Defense Tax Group. Consumers may now call and check their eligibility for a significant tax debt reduction. Financial stability is a major priority during this slow economy, so you're advised to dial this national hotline number now. 800-678-4191. If you owe more than $10,000 in back taxes to the IRS, you may now find significant relief. You could save thousands of dollars if you qualify. Call now and get free vital information and to check your eligibility for a significant tax debt reduction. Call the Defense Tax Group now. 800-678-4191. That's 800-678-4191. 800-678-4191.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us via Skype as well. You can Skype into the show here tonight at username lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us that way. The us includes me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And we're going to jump right into your calls and thoughts with Sean in Nevada. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Sean.
Hello.
Hey, you're on the air.
Yeah, I was just calling in reference to your guys' current conversation. I live in a town in called Pahrump, Nevada, where we have legal prostitution.
Ah, yes.
That's right.
We have two brothels here in the town where I live. We have multiple within a couple miles in the outlying towns, and there's never any problems with it. It actually stops people from having prostitution issues in the casinos here. You know, they don't actually go to the casinos here because there's no reason to. They can go right down the street and do it legally without any issues, and it stops all the issues that come along with it. You go into Vegas, where I work on the strip, I'm a dealer, and there's prostitutes all over the place. I'm a poker dealer, and we're always pointing them out and like wondering how much, I wonder how much she is, you know what I mean? It's like a big joke all the time because they're all over.
And they're not legally supposed to be operating in Vegas.
Nope, you can't operate in a town with more than 120,000 people or something like that. Or a county, excuse me, county with more than 120,000.
Oh, really?
Which pretty much is only two counties. It's Washoe County and Clark County, where Vegas is.
Interesting. Yeah, I didn't know that. I didn't know it's a state law that prohibits that, because I just figured it was each county that had outlawed it.
No, the state has a law that says if you have more than 120,000 people in the county, you cannot have prostitution, which just keeps them out of the two big counties, which are where Reno is, Washoe County, and Clark County, where Vegas is.
Huh. Cool, so, man.
But, yeah, it causes nothing but problems, you know what I mean? It causes, it's nothing but a big headache for security all the time. We're dealing with them, you see them. And they don't want to deal with it. All they do is, you know, they don't even call Metro or anything like that on them. They just take a picture of them and kick them out so that they don't get fined for it if they get caught in there.
Oh, the casino will catch a fine.
Yeah, the casino can catch a fine for it. You know?
Wow.
Yeah. There's a lot of weird stuff like that, like with underage gaming or prostitution. The casinos can catch a fine for it, so they have to kick them out when they see them.
Fascinating stuff.
Yeah, I guess it's one of those things, sort of like how a bar can get in trouble if they overserve somebody.
Overserve.
Like if anything illegal happens in your establishment, somehow it is your fault.
Yeah, and that's only state by state. You don't hear about that out in here in Nevada, bars getting held responsible for over-drinking. But, I mean, there's certain things where they're under, you know, gaming code and stuff like that. The casinos are under a lot of extra scrutiny for it.
And so in the town in Pahrump, is there ever a push to make it illegal or anything like that? Or is it something to where it's state level?
This is probably like one of the most conservative towns in the world, I swear. The average age in this town is 56 years old. It's a really old community.
Wow. Wow.
And it's you don't even hear about it. I mean, I sit on the Republican Central Committee here. I'm a pretty big activist out here, and we try and do a lot. And we work with the Republican Party because it's who wins all the elections, you know, plain and simply on the county level. And even locally, nobody even cares about it. All these old Christian conservatives that just drive you crazy, they don't even care about it. They don't talk about it.
Amazing.
It's not in their face. The places are out by themselves because their clients don't want to be seen. You know what I mean? It's a private industry. So they don't put them right here in the middle of town. They're out on the outskirts of town, and they got some space where nobody's around. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And it just keeps it safer, and I haven't found a negative of it yet.
Cool, man. Thanks for sharing that with us tonight.
My wife has gone down for it. They're very accepting. You can go down there. They'll give you a tour of the place. You know, it was kind of a fun experience. We did what we called Harry Reid night, because he came out trying to stand up against the brothel.
That's cool.
We wanted them closed down, so we did Harry Reid night at Sherry's brothel, just so that the headline in the newspaper would read Harry Reid night at Sherry's brothel, and that way it would just make him look bad just to screw with them.
Interesting. Sean, yeah, I mean, thanks for sharing your story tonight, man. I appreciate the info there from Nevada and what it's like. Apparently no big deal. 855 450 free, and that's how it should be. It's just people doing business with one another. It's just adults consenting to activities together. Why should it be anybody's business what two people or three people or however many people want to do with one another? If as long as no one's getting hurt, as long as no one's being coerced, then it's none of your damn business, right?
What if they want to get hurt?
Then if it's, okay, good point. As long as no one's getting hurt against their will.
That's a special request.
Yeah. Because there are dominatrixes, obviously, and people who are willing to cause you pain as long as you're willing to pay them for it. Or maybe somebody will do it for free for you, too, if you find the right person. 855-450-FREE.
There's a website where you can find that.
What is that?
FetLife.com.
Fet as in fetish?
Yes.
FetLife.com.
That's more of a social network, not a dating site.
Okay.
But yeah, it's for all types of various alternative lifestyle, as the escort mentioned it. So alternative lifestyle, it doesn't just mean homosexual, is what, you know, when I was a kid, like, alternative just meant gay. And now, you know, no, there's a whole bunch of other things. So there's like the swinger community. Yep. There's the BDSM. There's, you know, everything
all kinds
in between.
Of things. So, yeah, you can share your thoughts on that here. And also, Daryl, you had something you wanted to tell us in relation to escorts. Apparently, there's some naughty behavior on the part of some escort services where they're stealing people's Facebook pictures.
But you don't even want to hear my funny story about the time that I went
to the
strip club.
Oh, I totally spaced about that. I'm sorry.
Thanks, Ian.
Thanks for reminding me.
Where you got punched?
Oh, yeah, you
overheard
that,
didn't
you? Well,
you said you've been a bunch of strip clubs, right?
Yeah, I've been to a few.
Oh, a bunch. Okay,
Probably been to like three or four.
Three or four, all
yeah.
right.
So the one time that I actually, where I got hurt at one was
where
that.
Where was this, Idaho?
Yeah, it was at Idaho. Now, Idaho has a weird law, and I don't know if it's the same in every state, but it's a bikini bar if they're serving alcohol, and the girls are not allowed to be topless. It's a strip club, but they cannot serve alcohol, but they're allowed to be topless, but they're not allowed to take off panties.
That's pretty lame.
I know,
hold
right?
on. So you're saying if they're topless, no alcohol?
Right.
Correct.
Okay. No, I know in New Hampshire, if as long as they're wearing bottoms, they can serve alcohol, but they can't be fully nude and serve alcohol.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, I think it differs.
Pennsylvania has a couple full nude strip clubs that are BYOB, and they allow people to bring their own alcohol. So some people will go in and just like drag a cooler behind them full of beer.
That's
but
amazing.
I've always had a positive experience going there because I would go with my girlfriends. We'd, you know, pay for a couple dances, and then afterwards we'd go outside, and oftentimes the dancers would come out and, you know, talk to us, and they'd say, "Hey, how are you doing?" And they were just super nice girls.
Mm-hmm.
But the one strip club that this happened, it was right next to a bar. So people go, they get drunk, then they go next door, you know, because they don't serve alcohol next door. So my friends and I had stepped outside because my friends wanted to smoke, and there was this girl. She was drunk from having drunk at the bar next door. She was on her cell phone, probably going through some sort of breakup or drama with her boyfriend. Mm-hmm. She was really upset. And so she starts, like, moving around. She can't maintain her balance because she's wearing heels. They're just ginormous. And so my friend grabbed her from falling down. She's like, "Are you okay?" And then she just flails her arms up and says, "Leave me alone." She's swinging her arms. And I tried to go over to grab her from my friend, and she just won't get socked me right in the mouth.
God. Intended to. It wasn't an accident.
I don't know if it was an accident or she intended, but she was pretty upset.
She got you
not
good.
Her and yeah, I got a
ooh,
bloody lip. And the bouncer saw it, and he just like promptly took, you know, kicked that girl out, like he took her over, called a taxi. And then my friends brought me back inside, and they told one of the dancers what happened, and she's just like, "Oh, let me give you a free dance." So I got a free dance out of it, I guess, from having a bloody lip.
Okay, so now you said there was the bar next door,
yes,
right? So was the bar owned by the same people who owned the strip club?
I don't know about that. It probably, but I don't know.
Because this seems like it's a major downside, right? Like, you know, the idea of running a strip club is you sell alcohol to your clients. In this case, you're saying in Idaho, that can't happen.
Well, they can serve alcohol as long as the girls are, it's a bikini bar. They can't serve alcohol.
But then it's not a strip club.
Right, yeah.
I'm talking about at strip clubs.
Right, correct. Right?
So that would it would make sense then to own the bar next door.
And maybe
to where
they
you
did.
Then,
maybe there was some sort of like, you know, back padding or something like that between the owners. I don't know if it was.
Yeah, I wonder about that. Yeah. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Because what else do you serve at a strip club? Soda? Milk?
Energy drinks?
We're on the way here. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit Nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what the readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. FreedomsPhoenix.com constantly providing the information, the real news about government policies, and the real relationship we all have with the coercive government. The real condition of the economy, innovations in technology, breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media. The corporate media, nothing more than distributors of government propaganda. But now there's an alternative. FreedomsPhoenix.com. Constant news updates on the issues that affect your life in the most important ways. With liberty and property under constant attack, FreedomsPhoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda, and it encourages the participation of its readers. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com. That's Freedoms with an S, Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com. The revolution between the ears has already happened.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us on the radio here, toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking prostitution, escorts. We had an interview with a high-end escort earlier that we were sharing with you from businessinsider.com. You can go on our Facebook and Twitter and, of course, see a lot of the show prep that we use here on Free Talk Live. We post it over there. You can access our Facebook and Twitter by going to news.freetalklive.com, and that'll actually give you also a sign-up box where you can drop your email in there and get on our email list as well, which will keep you kind of up to date with the latest with Free Talk Live in the email world. So go to news.freetalklive.com. And joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Danica.
And Daryl.
And, Daryl, you were going to tell us about the escorts who are apparently jacking people's pictures online.
Yeah, so
and by jacking, I mean stealing.
Yes. The story here comes from DailyDot.com.
Okay.
It begins, "I have read and agree to the terms" is the biggest lie on the web.
Yeah,
that
sure is
the tagline yeah. for Terms of Service Didn't Read, a project that reviews the legal terms of service and use several digital platforms. While most of us are guilty of not having read the terms of service on every website,
I think everyone's guilty of that at some point.
There are an unscrupulous few who are guilty of actively violating these terms by taking content from other users and posting it elsewhere online. Such was the case when Adriana Henderson of Houston, Texas, posted photos of herself on Facebook and soon discovered that they'd been posted in advertisements for sexual services on websites like Backpage. Backpage, for those of you not familiar with it, is kind of like what Craigslist used to be.
It's like a dirty Craigslist, right?
Right. So the escort stuff that got kicked off of Craigslist several years ago, it's all on Backpage now.
Good. I'm glad to hear that.
The story here continues. As of last week, when she spoke to her local ABC affiliate about the incident, Henderson had not yet had them successfully removed. Henderson is one of many Facebook users to have their images stolen and misused elsewhere online. Mm. A woman in Nebraska discovered that someone was using her Facebook photos across multiple accounts and different names to plan meetings with men.
Wow.
An ex-boyfriend remade his entire Facebook profile to mirror that of his ex-girlfriend and posted numerous racist screeds on the site in an effort to get her fired from her job. Another scorned man posted numerous ads on Craigslist instructing men to come to his ex-girlfriend's house for sex. In another instance, several teen girls in Massachusetts had their photos stolen in 2012 and put on a website that hosts child porn, along with identifying information about the young women. Unlike the much-publicized cases of revenge porn, the stolen photos in these cases are not explicitly sexual, but they are repurposed for sexual services that can impinge on a person's safety, privacy, and reputation.
Hmm.
Few people understand the impact of having one's photo misused in this way, quite like the people actually advertising sexual services or sex workers themselves. In recent years, a number of sites have scraped data from sex worker advertising sites like Backpage and Eros and reposted the photos of sex workers in fake ads they did not place. Dana, who that is not her real name, says what ends up happening is you completely lose control over your image. Dana is an escort who discovered her image was being used across a number of other sites when she needed to remove her web presence.
Mm.
She says, once your material gets picked up by one of these leeching websites, it is permanently online. Yep. All of
and,
the cases.
And what are you going to do about it? I mean, how much effort can you really put into this? Because a lot of these companies that are doing this kind of shady business are likely not going to have an easy-to-access phone number or mailing address to where you could send some sort of legal threat or whatever. You know, you go to the Whois on a website. If you go to, like, whois.godaddy.com, you can type in any old website you want to, and it'll give you, in theory, it will give you who the owner of the site is, unless the owner of the site is paying to block that.
Right, that's privacy. $2 a year.
It's usually pretty cheap to make it so that it says domains by proxy instead of your actual name. And so it can be very, very difficult to track down who the person is that would be held legally responsible for taking these actions. And even if you are able to track down, you know, finally ferret out some kind of contact information for one of these sites, then again, still, you know, sending them an email isn't probably going to clear it up. You probably have to hire an attorney to send them a threatening letter saying, hey, you better pull these pictures down or else we're going to bring a lawsuit against you. And that probably will be enough to get them to comply, because usually a cease and desist does what it intends to do.
Right.
But if not, then you got a lawsuit on your hands. And how many of these sites are you willing to sue? How much time and money are you willing to spend just to try to cleanse the web of a picture that, you know, you don't want online anymore?
Right. The article here continues. It says, all of these cases make it clear just how easy it is for images to spread across the web in ways that profoundly impact a victim's life. Theft and misuse of people's photos elicits obvious sympathy for those affected. However, the knee-jerk response to create legal protections for the victims don't always take into account the broader implications for digital speech. Corrine McSherry, legal director for the Electronic Frontier Foundation, says, we want to have neutral platforms for speech, but that comes with a price. Facebook has policies expressly forbidding use of the platform for anything that is, quote, unlawful, misleading, malicious, or discriminatory, unquote, which arguably covers just about every one of the aforementioned cases. Facebook also states that repeated misuse of other people's copyrighted material or the creation of fake accounts using another person's information is against the terms of service. But victims don't always find Facebook especially helpful. Danielle Partridge's image was used to create a profile for another Facebook user who went by the name Karen Belinda Smith. When Partridge filed a complaint that the image was hers, she was reportedly told by Facebook, "We reviewed the account and determined that Karen Belinda Smith is a person who's using Facebook in a way that follows the Facebook community standards."
Wow.
The most basic tool to combat this misuse is to claim copyright infringement by issuing a takedown notice under the Digital Millennium Copyright Act, that's the DMCA, which does not require an attorney. Section 512 of the DMCA encourages cooperation by websites to remove this content by exempting them from liability for the copyright infringement in exchange for compliance.
I see.
And that is what Stefan Molyneux presumably used to get videos that he didn't like removed from YouTube. A DMCA claim of, that's my copyrighted material, take it down off of these other people's.
Even though Stefan Molyneux purportedly claims to not believe in intellectual property.
Right.
Yeah.
The story here continues. This is a powerful option for Facebook users whose photos have been uploaded to other websites without their knowledge. But as Jamie Williams of EFF notes in a blog post, among other problems with the DMCA, the increasing use of robots to detect copyright infringement means that a huge swath of legal content is being targeted for censorship. McSherry adds, in the name of assisting victims, we often don't think of the broader implications of legal decisions that encourage more censorship of the internet. Other legal tools are suing for defamation or for rights of publicity if an image is being used to promote commercial activities. Henderson could arguably sue for both, since a court might determine that associating her image with illegal sexual services harms her reputation, and because an escort site like Backpage is using her image for material gain. The story here continues. What is frustrating, of course, is that victims have to contend with both the anonymity of the internet, which often protects those responsible for stealing their images, and the cost of pursuing legal action. In the ABC segment featuring Henderson's story, reporters made attempts to call the person who had posted the ad with her photo. They were repeatedly met with claims that they had dialed the wrong number, or even with silence.
Yeah, I don't know. Who do you want? I mean, what? Yeah, I run this website. Okay. Even if they got the person to pick up.
No, so the photos were being used in a Backpage ad of,
right,
I'm an escort. Here's my photos. Call me.
They gave the number, and then you tried calling that number.
They called the number, and they were told, no, you've got a wrong number.
Right.
Or just the person would pick up and didn't say anything.
Yeah.
Wow.
So they were getting the person that posted the photo. It wasn't just, you know, like,
I see,
thank you
mean
for calling Backpage.
Right.
For
1-800
customer
Backpage
service,
how may I
press
your call?
1. For Ian, press 2.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
The story here continues. The author says, I browsed Backpage and came across a photo of an especially small-waisted woman on the first page of results that looked like it may have been culled from a Pro Anna blog. A reverse Google image search delivered 663 results.
Wow.
All right, well, we'll come back here in moments at 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts on whatever's on your mind. This is Free Talk Live.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA?
Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Lil Drums. Every bit as fun as a full-size Nestle drumstick cone and definitely cuter. Visit us at drumstick.com. Vacations are all about family time, but you don't have to leave home to have fun. Take one weekend a month and devote it to family activities. Pull out the board games and puzzles, serve up some treats, or have a picnic. Even without leaving home, you'll feel like you've really had some time away. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, May 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.25 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,212 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports the USA Freedom Act, which got its start as an NSA reform bill and has turned into a watered-down extension of the NSA surveillance program in general, is passed in the House, and Senate leaders have announced a Saturday vote on their version. The Senate is facing strong opposition on both sides from those opposed to surveillance and those wanting an even more straightforward approval. Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky already spoke against the bill, and some amendments are seemingly going to be needed to pass the bill. But if the USA Freedom Act needs to be reconciled with the House version, it may be too late, as the House has already gone into recess for the holiday. The Senate's alternate plan, also set for a Saturday vote, would be to try to extend the NSA surveillance for 2 months, giving them more time to sell a permanent extension. There, too, however, is no House approval, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claims assurances from House leaders that they won't try to push any short-term extension bill with virtually everyone gone on recess.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
UPI reports a Baltimore grand jury on Thursday handed down indictments for six police officers for their alleged role in the death of Freddie Gray. Baltimore City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby announced the indictments during a news conference on Thursday afternoon. When she announced those initial charges earlier in the month, all six police officers were arrested and released on bond. After the grand jury review process, reckless endangerment charges were added for all six officers, while false imprisonment charges were dropped. Officer Caesar Goodson Jr. was indicted on charges of second-degree depraved heart murder, involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, gross negligence manslaughter by vehicle, criminal negligence manslaughter by vehicle, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Goodson faces the most serious punishment of 30 years in prison for the murder charge. Officer William Porter and Sergeant Alicia White were each indicted on charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Lieutenant Brian Rice was indicted on charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, two counts of misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Officer Edward Nero and Garrett Miller were each indicted on charges of second-degree assault, two counts of misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Freddie Gray died on April 19th, 1 week after sustaining a spinal cord injury while in police custody. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports, Boy Scouts of America President Robert Gates said on Thursday that the group's ban on adult gay leaders needs to end, taking a step towards dismantling a policy that has caused deep rifts in the 105-year-old organization. Gates said at the group's national meeting in Atlanta that he does not plan to revoke the charters of Boy Scout councils that allow gay leaders. As Secretary of Defense, Gates helped end the Don't Ask, Don't Tell policy that barred openly gay individuals from serving in the military. He said he was not asking the Boy Scouts National Board to make any policy changes at the current meeting. The Irving, Texas-based organization lifted its ban on gay youth in 2013, but continues to prohibit the participation of openly gay adults. The selection last year of Gates as president of the Boy Scouts was seen as an opportunity to revisit the policy. Gates said he personally would have supported going further towards lifting the Scouts' ban on gay adults, but would not reopen the debate during his two-year term. The policy received its first major challenge in April when the first openly gay adult was hired as a summer camp leader by the Greater New York Council of Boy Scouts. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's The Onion Radio News. General Motors reports record sales of its new disposable car. This is Doyle Redland reporting. General Motors has announced a 56% increase in earnings this year, attributing much of it to February's wildly successful launch of the GMC WHIM, the first ever non-refillable disposable automobile. Debuting at a cost of $1,100 each, the vehicles are flying out of showrooms as quickly as dealers can stock them. WHIM enthusiast Glenn Shriver.
I recently consumed four vehicles driving from my home to Daytona Beach for the first annual WHIM Owners Convention. I've already collected all eight colors.
Rival automakers are preparing to counter with their own lines of disposable cars, including the Ford Temperare and the Chrysler Dumper. The 2002 Mitsubishi Ditch will be unveiled later this year with a projected sticker price of $799. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've been talking about escorts throughout most of the show here tonight. We had an interview with a high-end call girl from the authors of Freakonomics that we talked about earlier. Now, just recently discussing the issue with some, I guess, less scrupulous escort services that have been lifting photos from people's Facebook pages and social networking and then using those pictures to advertise their services, which, of course, is a fundamentally dishonest thing to do. And I can't imagine, you know, it's one thing for some company to use a picture of a hot girl just to get people to call in. But if you're using a picture of a girl on like a Craigslist ad or a Backpage ad, which we're just looking at some of these Backpage ads a moment ago in the studio, you're supposed to be connecting directly with the person in the Backpage ad, right? Unless they've got some kind of handler. So when you right. call that number, presumably it's supposed to be the girl who's in the pictures. And if you use fake pictures for your Backpage ad, the customer's going to know real fast when they show up.
I was
right?
just thinking that. Right. She's like, hey, I'm going to call and get this blonde here. But when you go and meet the blonde, she's actually brunette and looks absolutely nothing like her picture, then you're going to say, hey, what the heck is going on?
Right, or even if she is a blonde that is in the pictures that you end
but
up seeing.
But has a different body style or right. different face.
Yeah, I mean, these guys yeah. are going to be looking closely at these pictures, right? I mean, mm-hmm. this is all you get, right? You get the headline of whatever it says to entice you to click on this person, and then further, there's pictures. Many of them don't actually show the person's face.
Right.
And I guess that's because, you know, like in a place like New Hampshire, it's a relatively small place. You go, you look through these ads, and if everybody showed their face, you'd probably see people you know.
Sure.
Would be my guess. So that way you would have to meet that person in order to see what their face looks like. And I suppose maybe that's some of the context that these photos are being used, where maybe the person in the photo you don't actually see their face. Maybe it's a behind the person shot, and so therefore it, the person who's advertising could get away with representing that as themselves.
Right, or sometimes they'll do a crop, like they crop mm-hmm. just you know,
just to show
above
the body.
The neck, just yeah. to show the body, or they'll blur out the face, something along those lines. The article that I've been reading here from daily.com says, but what if you adjust your privacy settings so that Facebook photos can only be seen by your friends?
Okay.
Because, you know, presumably all of these other photos that were taken were from profiles where everything's public.
I would presume, yes.
What about if only your friends can see it? Well, an especially revolting case in Arizona makes it clear that that's no defense against people stealing photos.
Oh, boy.
A man stole photos of a Facebook friend's 9-year-old daughter from her page and posted them on a child porn site hosted in Russia, claiming to be the girl's father.
Okay.
Though Homeland Security intervened, the prospect of pursuing legal action against a website adds yet another layer to the headache of removing misused stolen content.
How do you take down a site in Russia from the United States?
I don't think you can.
Right.
The case also proves that there's no guarantee that Facebook friendship is a mark of trustworthiness.
That's true.
That's very true. You could be friends with people, then just figure that, hey, they're acquaintances, but they still have access to some of the stuff you let them access.
And
to.
There are ways within Facebook to have friends with restrictions, right?
Right.
So they have
right.
what's called acquaintances or whatever. And so you can
put them on restricted. That way they only see public things and not
yeah.
friends only.
That way it looks to them like they're your friend, but they're really not your friend, that kind of thing. I've never gotten into that level of detail personally. If I don't know a person, at least from real life, I won't accept their requests. But then again, I don't really care if somebody takes my pictures and puts them on a porn site. It really doesn't matter to me. Like, that doesn't, it doesn't matter. Like, so somebody sees my pictures on a porn site.
You know? I can just think of all of the people now that are going to scroll through your pictures on Facebook.
Yeah.
Just start adding you to gay porn sites.
They like already photoshopped his face on top of a giant squirrel.
Well, that was Johnson.
What?
Oh, yeah,
that,
okay. I'm just saying. They've already done something like
so
that.
So have, like, you know, Ian and Derek J. porn.
Well, there actually is
the
Derek
earth.
J. porn.
There is Derek J. porn.
Right, but yeah. you're not in it.
No.
Yet.
No, not yet.
Until somebody photoshops it, because you just said, I don't care if people take
my
pictures.
I don't care. I don't. I don't believe in intellectual property. So please, you know, take my pictures and do whatever you want with them. In fact, we even have
right,
on our...
Right, but you don't necessarily have to support intellectual property to think that people shouldn't be a-holes and...
I don't care what people do. It's just people posting things on the internet. People post all kinds of things on the internet. To me, it's like, okay, am I going to lose a job over this?
So if somebody... put up your telephone number and ad of you on Backpage.
Yeah.
You wouldn't care if you just started getting random telephone calls all through the day, because I don't care what people do.
Well, what am I going to do about it? Sue the person? Spend a bunch of my time and effort trying to chase down somebody like that?
I'm not saying you sue them, but don't say, I don't care what people do.
Well,
if
really, generally,
it's going
I don't
to
care.
Affect
I mean,
you, right?
I can
but
hit
it's
the block
going
button
to affect
on,
you.
I can hit the block button on things I don't want to see. You know, if somebody's sending me a bunch of voicemails I don't like, block them. And Google Voice lets you do that, which is pretty nice. So, I mean, I try not to be too worried about things like that. I didn't say
you had to worry about it. I'm just saying you don't have to tell people, like, go ahead, put my face on gay porn sites.
Well, basically, by saying I don't believe in intellectual property, you're saying go ahead and do whatever you want, right? So we have a Photoshop.
No, because
section.
You still, your reputation is not intellectual property. That's your reputation.
Yeah, but you don't own your reputation. You know, you don't get to tell other people what your reputation is. Each person has their own view of whatever your reputation happens to be. Some people might think I have a better reputation because I show up on a gay porn website. So it just depends
True.
On who just depends on who you're talking to. I mean, from the beginning on Free Talk Live, we've had a Photoshop section on our BBS, which is our forum, which you can go to bbs.freetalklive.com. It actually hasn't been used in probably like a year, that section specifically, the Photoshops. But a long time ago, it used to be much more popular, and people would cut out me and Mark's picture and put us on all kinds of ridiculous things there. It's fun.
Oh, I know someone took your face and put it on Sleepy the Dwarf. That was,
yes.
I mean, that's
oh, really?
not, that's not anywhere near, you know, pornographic, but it is quite amusing.
Yeah, that was kind of funny.
Well, it might ruin your reputation among people who don't like dwarves.
Ooh, I didn't think about that.
See, you need to get a lawyer. Lawyer up. Start suing
but
people.
I like dwarves, so.
Okay.
I never suggested that
dwarf
you
fetish.
Sue people. It's not a fetish, but I've always wanted to
no
be with a midget.
No wonder you like Tyrion Lannister so much.
Did you hear what he just said?
Did you Let hear me continue said? The article.
You didn't hear what he just said, did
what
you?
What did he just say?
You can find it in the archive. So the article here continues. It says, it's clear that we need more readily available and transparent material about the risk of sharing personal content online, particularly on platforms like Facebook that tend to bury their intellectual property pages. But more helpful than scaring everyone into never posting photos online again would be for more people to realize that just because they saw something on the internet doesn't mean it's true.
Mm. Yeah, exactly.
No matter how badly people want to believe that a woman is inviting them over to have sex or that they've caught a sex worker in the act of advertising, we can resist the urge to ruin lives like Henderson's by assuming the photos are authentic. Consider how many times we've all lied about reading the terms of service. The most empathetic and realistic thing we can do is consider the possibility that other people are capable of lying on the internet, too.
I think that's a good point. And, mm-hmm. you know, when it comes to these people who are so worried about someone taking their picture and putting it on a Craigslist or a back page ad, well, wait a minute. If you're going in to apply for a job and the person in human resources says, hey, didn't I see you on Backpage in the transvestite section? Well, that reveals that the person has been trolling the Backpage section for transvestites. And, like, you know, why would that affect your chances with getting that job?
Well, maybe. Hold on. Let me play devil's advocate here. Maybe they're hoping that you're a transvestite and you'll hook up with them.
To get
and
the
when
job?
They find out that you're not a transvestite, they're not going to hire you because they really wanted to hook up with you.
Yeah, I guess that's a possibility.
That's such a scheme.
But it seems so remote that the odds that you would be going into like some kind of job interview and that the person in there would happen to have seen you on Backpage.com
right.
in a fake advertisement. I mean, the chances of this happening seem so very, very slim.
I agree.
So it seems a little overblown to me. 855-450-FREE. But maybe you've been in a situation like this. Maybe somebody did take your picture without your consent. And then they did use it in some sort of circumstance like this, and it somehow blew back on you. You want to tell your story, we're here for you. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
I have a 70-pound Royal Standard Poodle. Her name is Zelia. And 3 years ago, Zelia's ears were a mess. She would have sticky, gooey, smelly discharge in her ears. We took Zelia to the vet 7 times of $150 every time. The vet offered no success at all. My wife and I are driving, and we hear some people on the radio saying D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E.
859-428-1000. The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
6 days after I started feeding her Dinovite, my dog's ear problems were cured. My dog no longer yelps. She can be petted without pain, and it's because Dinovite made our dog healthy again.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. We are here to take your phone calls if you share them with us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Whether you want to talk about the escort services, perhaps you've had some experience in that business. We were talking about the problem with some unscrupulous escort services taking people's Facebook photos and then using them on their advertising. And that apparently is very upsetting to some people. You can share your thoughts here tonight at 855-450-FREE. And then also we're going to talk about something a little bit more serious here in a moment, and that is people being scared about having sleepover parties for their kids.
Right.
We'll get into that here in a moment. Also, you need to protect yourself online, and certainly setting your Facebook settings to a more private way is one way of doing that. But there's other threats to your online safety and security.
Like Backpage.
Like the NSA.
Well, like, you know, common criminals who might be sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets or your very own internet service provider logging all the websites that you're visiting, logging that information and then saving it for years in some cases, maybe giving it away to the government or selling it to other companies. You can stop that from happening with ProXPN. Plus, with ProXPN's premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. So ProXPN.com/FTL is where you can go to get started with this global virtual private network. And you can start for free. All you have to do is download their free software for Windows, Mac, iOS devices, Android devices, and Linux. You go get started, get rolling with ProXPN. You're going to want to upgrade to their premium account, which I mentioned before. You can get that at 50% off the price of the annual account by using code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off. And by the way, that 50% off is good for the lifetime of the account. So when you're up to ready to renew for year number two, you get the same great deal from ProXPN, which is about $5 a month once you do the, you know, the division on that annual plan. So once again, go to proxpn.com/FTL, use promo code FTL50, and you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. So go to proxpn.com/FTL and use code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we shift gears from the more fun topic of escort services to a more serious topic of abuse, molestation at like sleepovers.
Yeah,
parents are getting paranoid, apparently. At least some of them are.
Well, that's how I took part of it when reading this article, and I sold a part on this article browsing Facebook, my friend had posted it, and I clicked on it because I was thinking, oh, what's wrong with sleepovers? Sleepovers are fun. I've had fun at sleepovers.
I've always had fun at sleepovers when I was younger.
So before you get into the serious article, did you ever have any interesting sleepover stories?
Oh, of course I have interesting sleepover stories.
Any that you would want to share?
Well, we played a much more mild version of Truth or Dare where I was dared to eat dog food and I ate dog food.
How was it?
It tasted like Captain Crunch without any taste at all. Like it had
really?
I had the crunch and texture of
what
Captain Crunch.
What kind of dog food?
I don't know, like Iams.
So dry dog food.
Dry dog food, yeah, not canned dog food.
Okay.
And then another friend of mine took the cinnamon challenge where you try and eat like a spoonful of cinnamon. Yeah, that wasn't pretty.
I don't remember anything that happened at sleepovers.
Oh, come on.
No, there was nothing exciting. I mean, it was a kid, you know? We'd play some video games and go to sleep, right? And, like, there really wasn't anything that
happened. Yeah, true. Daryl, how about you?
Okay, yeah. So I've got one that I wanted to make sure that I remembered before I forgot. One time, I think I was in fourth, maybe fifth grade, had a sleepover. I think it was sometime around my birthday or something. Mm-hmm. And, like, the first guy to fall asleep, for some reason, somebody had the brilliant idea of, let's put ketchup and mustard and toothpaste on him.
Where on him?
On his sleeping bag.
Oh, okay. Not
so
face,
not like on him, but on his sleeping bag. And
that's a mess.
One, it was a mess. Two, I didn't realize that they used all of the ketchup, all of the mustard, and all of the toothpaste. And then
is this your house?
Yes.
Okay.
And then my dad woke up in the middle of the night and walks into the living room and says, "Who's making tacos?" Because apparently, to him, it smelled like somebody had tacos.
Huh.
Like, he thought that we went to Taco Bell at 1 o'clock in the morning or something. I don't know. But it was just funny, but at the same time, like, one of those stupid, childish things that kids do.
Well, I mean, young adults do that crap, too, and it's really...
Yeah.
I'm not impressed by things like that, you know, making life difficult on somebody just because they went to sleep. That's not cool. I mean, doing something that is not damaging, like, you know, one of the classic stuff is usually pretty damaging and insulting, like drawing on somebody's face with a marker or
with
something
permanent
like that.
Marker.
Yeah, that's terrible. That's a horrible thing to do to somebody. I mean, if you do something that's, like, not harmful, okay, that's one thing. But most of the stuff I've seen in that vein is fairly mean and hard to clean up and awful.
Well, we did that at, like, drinking parties where you're not supposed to sleep, but I don't remember that ever happening at any sleepovers.
What I remember one thing, this wasn't from a sleepover, but just kind of things that people do when they pass out and in that category. It was at Liberty Forum years ago.
Oh, I know what you're going to say.
Where, I don't know if you know, but maybe you do, but there's a guy named Keith who has a real problem with alcohol, and he likes to drink very heavily. And so he actually passed out in the lobby at the Liberty Forum years ago, and so we stacked some cups on his head and took his picture. Now, that's fun, right? Like, that doesn't hurt anybody. It's not making a mess. It's just a silly picture of somebody with cups
on. This is Republican Keith.
That's right. Yeah.
I know which Keith you're talking about, and I've seen said photo. You're right. You know, it is so...
Harmless. That's
it's
a harmless,
harmless
prank,
it's just
right?
cups.
Right.
I mean, you didn't draw a horrible thing on his face.
It's something that you can still remember. It's something that was fun, and, you know, nobody gets hurt. Nobody has to go spend an hour scrubbing at their face to clean up whatever somebody's done to them. So parents are getting concerned, Danica, with sleepovers, or at least some parents are. Where's the story coming from? Tell me more.
The story is coming from a blogger, and it's the website is called chalies.com, which is C-H-A-L-L-I-E-S. He is a writer. He is a blogger. And he is specifically talking about a author by the name of Dr. James Dobson. Have you ever heard of him?
I have heard of that name.
Yeah, he founded Focus on the Family, is, you know, a Christian website about, you know, godly values. And while
it's also a radio show.
It is a radio show, and they do have radio shows. Now, while I'm not, you know, a very religious person, I read this kind of thinking, okay, this can apply to Christians and non-Christians alike. And so he starts up by saying James Dodson believes that children should not participate in sleepovers. The world has changed, he says, and has become too dangerous to let your children out of your sight for too long. In his book, Bringing Up Girls, he says, sadly, the world has changed in the last few decades and it is no longer a safe place for children.
Ridiculous. Now, this is Dobson who's saying this or the guy writing the article?
He's quoting from Dobson. Okay. This is the first part he's quoting from Dobson.
It's such ridiculous fear-mongering. I mean, we've barely even scratched the surface on this article.
Right.
And, I mean, we're going to continue on here in a moment. But the idea that it's more dangerous for children now is, I think, absolutely ludicrous.
And you can't let children out of your sight. Well, what about, like, the 8 hours a day that
you send to
people
school.
Are asleep? Well, I'm just thinking
school.
The 8 hours a day that you're asleep. When the children are in a different room.
There are right. more ways now to connect with your kids than there ever have been in the past. I mean, what kid doesn't have a smartphone on their person? They can you can put GPS tracking apps on your
right,
kid's
exactly.
phone. I mean, look, we'll come back with more. 855-450-FREE. Share your thoughts. It's Free Talk Live.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from hiddenholster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. The original hidden holster.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
If you want to move to the Free State and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you a sneezer? If you're not, can you get close to one? I don't literally mean someone sneezing. Sneezer, as defined by marketing guru Seth Godin, is an opinion leader. When a sneezer mentions something, other people catch what Godin calls the idea virus. Seth Godin says some people are more likely to tell their friends about a great new idea. So identifying and courting sneezers is a key success factor for idea merchants. His book, Unleashing the Idea Virus, is the most downloaded ebook in history, and you can download the whole book free. That's how he's making his idea contagious. Click tips tricks, and other stuff to help you cut through the clutter at www.survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We're talking about overprotective parents. In this case, parents who have decided, apparently in advance, to not allow their kids to have sleepovers.
Right.
That's the story that you're going to be sharing with us further from here in moments, Danica. And you're welcome to share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. Maybe you are one of two parents who has decided to not allow sleepovers. And what are your reasons? We're going to hear this one guy's explanation here in a moment over at Chalice.com, which is apparently some sort of a Christian blog site.
Yeah, he's a Christian author and blogger.
Anyway, we'll get into that here a little bit further. Also, want to invite you to check out Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree at victimlesscrimespree.com. If you have not yet seen the movie, you can go and see it for free. It is a great movie, if I do say so myself. I happen to be the executive producer of the film, but that's not why I'm biased for it. I think it's really an awesome movie. I really do enjoy it, and you can go and watch it totally free. There's also a director's cut DVD available with more than 7 hours of bonus footage. You can go grab it all over at victimlesscrimespree.com. It features our very own Derek J, who is our Monday night co-host here on Free Talk Live. Although Derek will be out this coming Monday, and I hear a rumor that a certain independent newsman video journalist may be sitting in for Derek J on Monday night, which could be a lot of fun. So anyway, let's continue here. Danica, you had just opened this story up. He's quoting from James Dobson, which is this ultra-right-wing kind of Christian Bible thumper character who is saying that it's so dangerous. The world is so scary. We can't let kids sleep over with their friends.
He's quoting Dobson by saying the threat can come anywhere, which is obvious, including neighbors, uncles, stepfathers, grandfathers, Sunday school teachers, coaches. The list goes on. We're all aware of that. So Tim Challey says that
it's more likely, by the way, to be the uncle or the grandfather or somebody in your family than it is to be the neighbor, or it is to be your friend's parents or something like
that. Yeah, how many stories have we heard where it was a trusted and loved member of the family that did these molestations? So Tim Challey was saying that he finds himself both agreeing and disagreeing. I agree with the nature of some of his concerns. Before my children were even old enough to ask, Eileen, his wife, and I talked it through, and we decided that we would not allow our kids to sleepovers. We determined that we would make it a family rule. Our children would not be allowed to spend the night at their friends' homes. We believed they would face a particular kind of vulnerability if they found themselves alone and in bed outside our care, and we wanted to protect them from them.
So, are these people who never actually went and slept over at a friend's house? I mean, how overprotective do you have to be to think your kids are going to be vulnerable?
Things were different when we were children, Ian.
That's always the excuse.
I don't think it's always the excuse, though.
I don't think it's true, though,
now,
right?
To draw a little bit of clarification,
child molesters were around in the 50s, like they're around today.
But no, things were different. When we were kids, we didn't have cell phones.
That's right.
You had a landline that your parents would always have the friend's telephone number, and unless they were on a call with somebody else, they'd be able to get them by calling the house.
Oh, yeah. I was never allowed to spend the night at my friend's house unless there was a number and my mom had actually met the girl's parents.
Now, that makes sense. You wouldn't want to just let your kid go spend the night at someone's house.
Yeah, that's just stupid.
At someone's house that you don't know anything about the people there. I would presume, I'm not a parent, but if I were, I would want to, go out to dinner with these folks or something, at the very least get to know them in some way, shape, or form, have a barbecue together or something like that. Spend some time getting to know them as a family and, feel comfortable with them taking care of your kid for 24 hours or whatever.
Now, Chalice does make a clarification and says that they do stay at their grandparents and they do stay with his sisters when they visit it.
Then they're in the greatest danger in that particular case.
Right, they've not stayed at a friend's house. And he also says that now that his son is older and is now 14, they've relaxed the rules, but it actually depends on the circumstances. So I imagine he's probably talking about kids under a certain age, 13, 14 or something.
How old were you when you had your first sleepover?
I slept over at my friend Rachel's house, and I was probably 8 or 9.
I was as young as 6.
Yeah, I was probably 6 or 7.
I know for a fact I was as young as six. It was one of the neighbor's houses that I went and slept over at, and we kind of fooled around with with each other. But that had nothing to do with
it. So that you could play video games?
No, no. This was actually somewhat about my age. That was the later on that I fooled around with an older neighbor who, again, completely consensual on my part. This was not molestation, even though some people will say that it was, because you couldn't possibly consent at age 10. Well, anyway, I did consent, and that's a whole other story. But what you're saying here is interesting, Danica, from this guy's perspective, saying that, oh, I don't want to let them go to their friends' houses. But fine, you can go to my sister's house, who could be a pervert, or you could go to my grandparent, you know, the grandparents' house, who could be a pervert or whatever.
Sure.
I mean, because as we pointed out, it's the family members who are the most likely to be a child molester or some sort of child rapist.
And his thinking is that, oh, as long as they go to someone in my family, they're going to be perfectly okay.
Right, which it's is ridiculous.
Not necessarily.
And
true.
I'm not saying don't send your kids to your family members' right. houses. I'm just saying, from his perspective, if the idea is to insulate and shield his kids from any possible chance of having somebody do something bad to them without their consent, then you would not want to send them to your friends or to your family members' houses.
The reason we drew the rule so firmly was that it removes exceptions and explanations. We knew ourselves well and realized that if we drew up a list of exceptions, we would inevitably broaden that list over time. Not only that, but we did not want to explain to family why we allowed our children to stay with others but not with them. So sleepovers were just taken right off the table without exceptions or individual explanations. And so he says, in this way, I agree with Dobson that there is wisdom in avoiding sleepovers, but here is where I disagree. That the risk is that much higher today than it was decades ago.
Okay, so he disagrees on that point. Okay, so I'm with him there. It is not, I think, any riskier today. If not, you could argue it's even safer today.
It's riskier today because children are not allowed to play outside. You let your kids play outside and the cops are going to come pick them up and steal them and keep them for like 6 hours before you even know. That's how today is different.
Some places, that's true.
Now, he goes on to say, when I was young, I had some bad experiences with sleepovers.
Oh.
This is why. This is where we get to the draw of it. Nothing devastating happened to me, but I did learn that sleepovers bring a certain vulnerability and that children often behave foolishly in these circumstances.
I'm sorry to interrupt. I wish he would have been more specific. What were his bad circumstances? He doesn't say. He just brushes right over it, right?
Yeah,
like,
pretty
much. I had a bad time. What, somebody is big? Did the big brother of somebody's house you were at make you cry? You say something mean to you? Well, I mean, I had a bad experience playing duck hunt once when I was at a sleepover. The dog kept laughing at me because I kept missing the ducks. I mean, is this what?
I got concussions playing hide and seek. That doesn't mean that people shouldn't play hide and seek.
Right.
I mean, while I agree
although
that-
I will say, if you're going to play hide and seek in a church activity center, do it with the lights on because, you know, like, we would turn the lights off, and then you only had the emergency exit lights, and it made it, you know, like that much more fun because you couldn't really see where people were.
Sure.
But that's how Daryl ran into doors and dove into pool tables and ran into a steel door frame attached to a concrete wall.
And I definitely agree that there are some sketch things that happen at sleepovers, but molestation can happen anywhere. I was molested as a young girl in a neighbor's house with my parents in the same house. Like, it can happen anywhere.
By the neighbor?
By the neighbor's son.
Oh, my.
I was 8 years old, and he was about 13 or 14, and he knew better than to do what he did. Basically, what happened is that he took me into his room. He started kissing me. I started getting uncomfortable. He started feeling me. I told him to stop, and then we were told to go upstairs, and then that was the end of it. And then at the end of the night, I felt weird. I knew something bad had happened, and I told my parents, and my parents believed me, and we never saw that family again.
Did that change how they approached allowing you to sleep over at other places?
And
this
not
wasn't
so
even
much
a sleepover, right? This was just, you were over
we
there.
Right, it was a 4th of July weekend, because I remember because my mom's birthday was relatively after that. It did not necessarily affect me. I was still able to have sleepovers with my friends, but it did affect me in the way that I continued to grow up. My parents were super overprotective of me. Whenever I played a game of tag, I would get scolded because a boy touched me, and he could have touched me inappropriately. And dating was very hard growing up. Like, I don't think I really had any serious dates until I moved out, and I didn't move out until I was 20. So that was, 12 years later?
That sounds similar to me. My parents, I remember I asked them once if I could go, you know, ask a girl out on a date, and they told me no. You know, okay.
Yeah, that one instance affected them more than it affected me.
We'll come back with more here. Your thoughts, share them at the toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Is it more dangerous now than it has been in the past for young people? Are sleepovers a scary thing? It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Now, kid, I know you look at me and think, man, that guy knows everything. And you're right, I do. But occasionally, even I get stumped. I know, hard to believe. But when I need help, I get it from Grainger. Grainger can solve just about anything, from finding the right products to advice on installation to troubleshooting. Grainger gets me what I need right when I need it. When a guru needs a guru, who does a guru call? Guru calls Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Grainger.com, or stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
Are you suffering from EP? The symptoms include fraudulent charges to your credit card. Your subway card says it's empty, but you bought it yesterday. Someone's been in your hotel room, but the desk clerk says they only show you entering the room. These are signs of EP, electronic pickpocketing. Payment cards, transit cards, even hotel room keys use a radio chip, so you can just wave your card at the register, the turnstile, or your hotel room door. But what's convenient for you is also convenient for thieves, waving scanners to electronically pickpocket you without even touching you. The good news is there's a cure. ID Stronghold has created leather wallets and clutches that have built-in EP protection. Layers of shielding material cleverly concealed in a beautiful leather wallet that stops the symptoms of EP. Go to IDStronghold.com now and get the cure. IDStronghold.com. Warning, ID Stronghold wallets could lead to feelings of safety and security, comfort in crowds, and euphoria. If you experience these emotions, immediately inform your friends and family about IDStronghold.com so they can feel better too.
Free Talk Live.
Sometimes you have to do things in emergencies that you don't do in normal times.
Like lock up Japanese Americans?
Look, you don't believe in the internment of the Japanese Americans?
The hell I don't. I don't believe in locking somebody up for not doing anything wrong.
Let me tell you something. There were Japanese Americans who assisted Japanese soldiers in the Hawaiian Islands at that time.
So grab all the families and throw them in a concentration camp. That's a great solution, Lou. That's something that should happen in the land of the free,
right? I don't even like you using the term concentration camp.
That's what they were, Lou.
Because they were not death camps. They were.
It doesn't matter if there weren't gas chambers on the premises.
They were not death camps. You see, you're using euphemism.
I call them a concentration camp. You're concentrating people all in one location, Lou.
I don't, you're giving it an implication that it does not have.
I think you should go to the Japanese Americans and ask them, Lou.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts here on the radio with us. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, it's Ian,
Danica,
and Daryl.
Sleepovers. Apparently, some parents are deathly afraid of this sort of childhood rite of passage. I don't know what you want to call it.
7 minutes in heaven, spin the bottle, and all those
what
kinds of things.
What is 7 minutes of heaven? Is this
a girl
game?
You go into a closet with a guy and you make out with them for 7 minutes. I think that's what.
Now, how many sleepovers are cross-gender? I mean, meaning
I never had any boys at the sleepovers I went to.
Yeah, I've never, and there were never any girls at the sleepovers I went to. That's
at the age I have them, it's just kind of like, ugh, boys, cooties, ugh.
Okay.
Like, we just never did that.
I was still sleeping over at my friends' houses and vice versa into my early teenage years, I would say. And so I was definitely interested in girls.
Sure, yeah.
At
as I got
time.
Older, I was too, but it was just always girls.
Yeah. So I've never heard of a cross, I guess, what do you call that? Gender, not cross gender.
Co-ed.
Co-ed.
There we go. Co-ed. Never heard of that, but I imagine in some more
open-minded
families it happens.
More older teen. I think that's more like an older teen sort of thing.
I would think that parents would be less likely to let kids sleep over or young people sleep over if they were in their teenage years.
Oh, they probably snuck in somehow, maybe.
Yeah, normally, I guess when I consider a sleepover, I'm considering it being done with parental consent, meaning
right.
that the parents know that you're in the house.
No,
that kind
I agree.
Of thing.
I'm saying that you're inviting someone of the opposite sex and they're probably snuck in some way.
Or it will be a co-ed party that's not intended to be a sleepover, mm-hmm. but then, you know, like some people will sleep over anyway.
If we've got, I think is there any more to this story? We're pretty much.
He kind of
it.
Goes on a little bit about why he came to that way.
We might come back to that here in a moment then. Let's go to Marla, though, because you can bring up whatever you'd like. Marla, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Danica, and Daryl.
Hi.
Hi, Marla.
Hi. How are y'all doing?
Good. Go ahead with your thoughts.
I had a comment about your last segment about the media, you know, playing up. You know, the racial part of the police killing.
You are listening to the show in delay broadcast for anybody just tuning in who's confused because we've been talking about sleepovers and things like that. But you're certainly welcome to comment. You can call in about anything. So, yeah, the media, racial, go ahead.
Yeah. My comment is that, you know, you were saying the media plays up, you know, when black lives get killed and, you know, that's partially the fault, that it's not everybody's life matters. And my point is I think you left out a critical part of it, is that when we have a president and attorney general, Obama and Holder, who send representatives to the funerals of those people who were criminals, by the way, that it enhances the fact that only black lives matter when they're shot by police, because more white people are killed by the police than black people are killed by the police. And we've just had two policemen murdered here in Mississippi just not long ago. So all lives matter is my point. And our president shouldn't just, you know, take out the black lives and, you know, talk about them and send representatives to them.
I see where you're coming from, Marla. Thank you for sharing your thoughts tonight. By the way, where were you calling from in Michigan?
I'm in Tupelo, Mississippi.
Oh, okay.
Birthplace of Elvis Presley.
All right, that makes more sense. Makes more sense because I think they got the call screening was a little bit messed up. They got the wrong two letters for Mississippi. I think it's MS for Mississippi. Oh. Thanks for the call, Marla. I appreciate it. Thank you. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. So she's listening to WKMQ there in Tupelo.
Were you trying to figure out where Tupelo, Michigan was?
No. There wasn't a city listed. It was just the state listed for her. And I always like to know. I always like to know which station folks are listening to.
Right. Like because it helps us know.
That's just nice to know. That's just interesting. It's nice to be able to call them out and say, hey, thanks for listening to WKMQ in that particular case. And I agree with where she's coming from. I think all human lives matter. And certainly, I don't know how likely it would be whether Barack Obama or Eric Holder would go to somebody else's funeral. I'm not going to make a statement about that. To me, that's irrelevant. That's just playing politics. They're just, you know, schmoozing and trying to get reelected or, you know, play to their party or whatever. And I don't really concern myself with all the political side of those things. So back to the story here from the Christian blogger who is kind of freaked out and has not allowed his kids to ever, ever have a sleepover at anyone's friend's house. And I presume the reverse will also be true in that they would not allow friends to have a sleepover at their home, but they don't really make that clear.
He doesn't make that clear, but I imagine it would probably be the same way because, you know, he feels that you know, there's no way to make any sort of exceptions kind of thing.
So, well, right, because
no,
if you were to allow their friends to come over, then their friends will inevitably say, well, why can't you come over to our house?
Right, and they can't monitor their children 24/7, so they can't, you know, see if the kids are doing something mildly inappropriate.
Well, this same blogger, I was looking at, was it Challie or whatever?
Challie's, yeah. Challie's? TimChallies.com.
So I went and I looked at some of his other blog posts, yeah, and there was one of them, this really lengthy post about their family plan to protect their kids from pornography on the internet. And then he goes into...
Good luck with that.
Yeah, exactly. He goes into...
They're not going to have the internet at their house?
Well, no. He goes into a very lengthy explanation of the kind of blocking software or features and things like that. It's their kind of their plan for what to do with fixed computers, mobile devices.
Yeesh.
Yeah, so they've got a big, big plan there about how to keep their kids away from naked pictures.
Well, I certainly hope it works out for them.
It won't.
No,
there's just no chance that that's going to work out. And keeping, you know, having that mindset of you can't have this, stay away from it, is only going to drive, in my opinion, it'll only drive kids towards it.
Let me go see that thing that I can't have.
Exactly.
I absolutely agree, because when you restrict it and don't give any sort of logical or reasoning behind it, they're just going to...
Jesus, Danica, Jesus.
Yeah, jeez. And they're just going to try and find any way around it. And, you know, I did it. I'm sure you found ways around to get to your vices. Everyone has, you know,
is it a vice?
Guilty pleasure or something that seems forbidden. It's forbidden fruit.
Yeah,
so
yeah. That's certainly true. For me, it would have been Playboy magazine, I think, on the school bus. Somebody brought one, was sliding it on the floor. So we would slide it from like the front of the bus to the back. And
okay.
That way everybody could look at it.
I'm not a parent. I know you're not a parent, but I feel that a parent actually sat their kids down and said, hey, this is why we don't allow such and such. These are the reasons why. And, you know, they give logical explanation to the kid. And that would be a much better way of going about it than saying, nope, no sleepover for you. Go to bed. No friends for you. I mean, don't you feel that?
Maybe they are explaining it to their kids.
Maybe. I don't know. They don't really go into that much detail.
Son, we don't want you to get molested by your friend's parents. Which really, I mean...
What's molested?
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good point. But maybe they wouldn't explain it. You're probably right.
In the explanation where you're saying that they're going to go to all these preventive measures from blocking pornography, like, do they even explain pornography? Or are they just going to go around and make sure to have all these blocks and so that the topic
never
comes
up? Yeah.
It
never comes up, and they'll probably use such broad terms to block that the children will not be able to learn about the little furry creatures that chop down trees with their big teeth and build beaver dams.
That actually kind of reminds me of something along those lines years ago. I remember my mom's friend telling her that they were using kind of an email or web service called Integrity Online. And she said that it was causing problems because her daughter was trying to do a research paper about breast cancer, and she couldn't find it. She couldn't find it because Integrity Online would not allow her to type in breast.
Ridiculous.
In the search. Yeah. It's just like, really?
How do you find recipes for cooking chicken breast?
Right.
Or turkey breast? What do I do with my turkey breast leftovers? And you
or finding out what
no
a pussy
results.
Willow is. You know, what kind
that
of things
knowledge
are just,
is forbidden.
It's mind boggling. You know, now that you brought that, I'm just thinking, you know, geez, really, like, parents are really being super overprotective. Yeah. And in my experience, that's way more.
If you want to protect the children, just block Urban Dictionary and 4chan.
I am glad my parents didn't have to deal with this. They didn't. I mean, my dad was actually like a computer guy or whatever. So certainly if software like that existed, he could have done something like that. But I don't think he cared that much about it. And back when I was getting online, there were BBSs, which was these dial-up services. And some,
wait on that pixelated porn to depixelize.
Some BBSs did have GIFs that you could download. Yep, and that's how I got my first porn collection.
Oh yeah, my parents always said, "Oh, you're not allowed to be on the internet while we're not here." Well, there would be 2 or 3 hours in the afternoon. They're not home, and guess what I'm gonna do?
Yeah.
I'm gonna be on the internet. Oh, I hear the garage door rise up. All right, log off computer, go back to doing your homework. No one ever knew.
That sounds familiar.
That's just what I'm saying. Like, you know, kids are going to find a way to get around those rules.
I totally remember listening for the garage door.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Hey, so as far as, you know, your kids and what you want to do, obviously that's your business, but I think that if you're on this guy's side, you're super paranoid. As long as you know the parents that your kids are going to their house, what's the big deal?
No, I don't see a big deal. And I'm not even a parent. I would never tell anyone how to parent their kids, but I mean, just, you know, come on. Seriously, stop being so paranoid.
So we will see you tomorrow night. And don't forget to check out Daryl's website. It's fpp.cc. That's where you can get lots more of Daryl in written and in audio form. fpp.cc. And freetalklive.com. See you tomorrow.
Here's I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Hey,
who do you think
you
are?
Excuse me. There is no video and audio allowed in this
office. No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make...
Wait,
you wanna count.
Now. Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Seditious Sirens is next after the news on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, May 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.25 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,212 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $237. Antiwar.com reports the USA Freedom Act, which got its start as an NSA reform bill and has turned into a watered-down extension of the NSA surveillance program in general, is passed in the House, and Senate leaders have announced a Saturday vote on their version. The Senate is facing strong opposition on both sides from those opposed to surveillance and those wanting an even more straightforward approval. Senator Rand Paul of Kentucky already spoke against the bill, and some amendments are seemingly going to be needed to pass the bill. But if the USA Freedom Act needs to be reconciled with the House version, it may be too late as the House has already gone into recess for the holiday. The Senate's alternate plan, also set for a Saturday vote, would be to try to extend the NSA surveillance for 2 months, giving them more time to sell a permanent extension. There too, however, is no House approval, and Representative Justin Amash from Michigan claims assurances from House leaders that they won't try to push any short-term extension bill with virtually everyone gone on recess.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
UPI reports a Baltimore grand jury on Thursday handed down indictments for six police officers for their alleged role in the death of Freddie Gray. Baltimore City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby announced the indictments during a news conference on Thursday afternoon. When she announced those initial charges earlier in the month, all six police officers were arrested and released on bond. After the grand jury review process, reckless endangerment charges were added for all six officers, while false imprisonment charges were dropped. Officer Caesar Goodson Jr. was indicted on charges of second-degree depraved heart murder, involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, gross negligence manslaughter by vehicle, criminal negligence manslaughter by vehicle, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment. Goodson faces the most serious punishment of 30 years in prison for the murder charge. Officer William Porter and Sergeant Alicia White were each indicted on charges of involuntary manslaughter, second-degree assault, misconduct in office, and reckless endangerment.